Hello, hello, welcome in. Hi Ryan, how you doing? We were just listening to some Usher. I just kind of started a radio, so it'll play some other stuff too, but I might want to go back to just more Usher. We'll see. But yeah, I hope everyone's had a good weekend. The last time I saw you guys was Wednesday, and we were doing some Not So Berry. And then today we're gonna be doing some Not So Berry. When we finished off last time, we had gotten engaged. Yeah, we had gotten engaged. Our mint gen gal got engaged to the guy that she's been like, I don't know, I don't even want to say on and off with. They were like just kind of like on, but like not in a good place. Like they didn't have like a solid like relationship. And then like they got together, he asked if he could move in, and we were just like, yeah, I guess, like, why not? And then we got engaged at the during last stream, and I did take some pictures after stream, and I put some of those in the Discord, and then one of them I did use for the YouTube thumbnail for that video, so those are up. I took a lot of pictures. I'll probably use them like as we go, like for different things. I don't take pictures like after every stream of like that we'd play Not So Berry. I kind of just take some here and there. Sometimes I'll just do like normal screenshots of me playing, but there's just something different about having like a posed like pair of sims, or like a pose sim as opposed to like just like a gameplay like screenshot. Sometimes I like the posed ones better for thumbnails, but I don't always do it. It just kind of depends for when I do my VOD uploads. But yeah, if you're not caught up, I think I saw that actually a lot of people seem to, thank you. all those links there are my YouTube. The second one is my VOD channel, so that's the one that says Play With My VODs, obviously. But yeah, it's I've been uploading pretty consistently on there for like, I don't know, the last couple weeks. I'm not sure anymore. But yeah, it seems like a lot of people have been catching up on the Not So Berry. There's a playlist, so it's a little bit easier if you just want to like press play on the playlist and it'll go through them. But yeah, I'm really enjoying Not So Berry a lot. I should probably pull up the rules again, because we're gonna, I am pretty sure we're gonna be aging up our mint gen into an adult. She's a young adult right now. I think we're gonna be aging her up to an adult. And we're doing pretty well. Yeah, we need to master the scientist career and complete the chief of mischief aspiration. We're like getting pretty good progress with those. And then we have to master, oh, mischief and logic skills. I don't know if I noticed that. We're gonna have to work on those. I think we've been like passively doing them as we are working on other things, so I'll have to check how our progress is on that. And then we also have to complete the elements collection. I think we are just missing two elements, and I think they might be on the alien planet, so I kind of gave up looking for them like at work and stuff like that, or asking our coworkers for stuff. So I'm just probably gonna put a pause on the elements collection. Like technically she has until like, you know, we pass on the gen, but even then, like if we're literally just working on the elements collection and like her mischief and logic skill, like when she's like an elder, like that's not gonna be a big deal. We can like simultaneously be working on stuff with like our second gen, which is the rose gen. And we have been kind of thinking as we've been playing, you know, if we're going to get her pregnant soon. So yeah, we'll kind of see like if we do that today. But yeah, just like kind of chill, like productive, but like I'm kind of like in a chill mood. I feel like I haven't slept well since probably the last time I saw you guys. I just can't sleep well when you guys aren't around. No, it's like, it's, I don't know, like I just have been so like tossing and turning in bed so much lately. Like I feel like I haven't slept well since like last Wednesday or like last Thursday. So I'm hoping that I can get some finally get some sleep today. But I do have to wake up kind of early tomorrow. Well, I don't have to, but maintenance is supposed to come tomorrow to our apartment. Maybe. Oh my goodness, thank you so much. Let me get you a stamp. How are you doing? Thank you.
Almost commented. So hey, without my sub. Long out, but you, but I'm feeling 32 months.
Yay, I'm feeling 32. Thank you so much for the resub. But yeah, now you can do your sub high. Feel free. Thank you again for that sub. I put a stamp on my face for you. But yeah, did you watch the Super Bowl yesterday? What'd you think? Hey, M. Was that a 5 streak? Oh my gosh, thank you for the streak. Thank you for shouting out, M. Hello, friends. Oh, hi. Oh, hi. How are you? Is that an explodey emote? How you're feeling right now? Hi, new student. How are you doing? Of course I watch. I feel like I can't remember if I watched last year's Super Bowl. I'm pretty sure I did, but I literally don't remember anything about it. Like, I'm pretty sure I haven't missed a Super Bowl in a while. But honestly, after they're over, I don't remember much. But I still remember yesterday's Super Bowl pretty well. So I don't know, for, I don't know, the next like 48 hours, I'll probably still remember things. I'm playing Valorant. It's all I feel right. I feel like that emote is pretty, like, summarizes how playing Valorant kind of feels. I haven't been playing, like, I don't know, like, any shooting games really recently. Like, I haven't played Fortnite, like, at all this season. Like, any other my games that have, like, combat in them, I haven't been playing at all. I've been mostly just playing, like, cozy games, like, exclusively. I wore my Taylor gear. I felt bad at the end with my depressed family around me in their Niner gear. Yes, because I forgot that you're also from the Bay Area. Yeah, I texted my mom right after. I'm like, sorry. I'm like, sorry, mommy. Because, yeah, I've been a Niner fan, like, since I was a baby. I think I have, like, a baby picture of me in, like, Niner gear. I should post it, like, in the Discord or something. Yeah, my family has, like, raised me to be a Niner fan, and I am in general. I just don't know this team. I haven't kept up with sports since, I don't know, since I was in high school, like, when I lived with my family and we had cable and everything. Yeah, I just found some, like, Christmas pictures of me in, like, Niner gear. I'll try to crop some, maybe, and put them on the Discord if I remember. But yeah, like my family are pretty big fans. But like, I was kind of cool either way. I was kind of cheering for both sides. I was like, yay. I think by the end, I was like a little sad. I was a little sad that the Niners lost, but I don't know. It's just like putting aside like my personal feelings towards the Niners and like my history with them. I just felt like it was more fairy tale, more fun that the Chiefs won. I don't know. If you're a Niner fan, I'm so sorry. But like, just like the year that they've had and like last year and like all of the attention that they've gotten because of, you know, obviously because of Taylor, like, you know, let's not beat around the bush. Like, it felt right that they win. Right? Like I felt like it would have felt very like the bad ending to a book if they didn't win, even though like my Niner heart would have been happy that they won. I just feel like for the narrative that like the fantasy that I was building in my head, it made sense that the Chiefs won. Aldi, I've been stalking Taylor and Travis after their after game love affair cuteness, right? I've been seeing so many clips of them like partying after. I just feel so bad for her. Like, I love that they're being so cute, but like, I just feel like they all must be so tired. Like, Taylor, obviously, because she's been on tour, but then also just for like the whole team, they must be so tired. But obviously, they want to celebrate, so they can't be that tired. But I would be so tired. And then Patrick Mahomes was already like at Disneyland this morning because, you know, obviously he has that we're going to Disneyland like sponsorship. Yes. To fulfill, and he's like on the parade float like in Disneyland with Mickey and Minnie and his kids, and he's just like he must like want to just go to sleep so badly. I wanted my home team to win even though I'm not into sports. I wanted the family team to win because I was I was like, I kind of was just happy either way. But yeah, I did feel bad for the Niners because they've been trying to get a 6th Super Bowl since I was a baby, because I think that they said that they've been questing for 6 since like for like 28, 29 years. I'm like, that's rough, buddy. Like the Chiefs have won like what, like 3 times in the last 5 years, or at least they've gone 3 times in the last 5 years. I'm like, you know, they could share the wealth a little bit. But, you know, if they're good and they're going to win, they're going to win. Hi, Con Kennedy. How are you doing? I hope you're having a good day. But yeah, I enjoyed watching the game. I in general do like sports. I just don't keep up with it as much as I used to. Like, when I was in college, I didn't have access to watch sports. Like, we didn't have cable. Like, I almost never watched like normal TV when I was in college. Like, I mostly just rewatched Gilmore Girls while I was studying. I was constantly studying. So, and like when I was at home, like sometimes I would come home for like if I was like at home in the Bay Area, like I'd watch games with my family. But like I like it wasn't something I was like chasing after when I didn't have access to it as easily. It's not like I was like going down to the local sports bar to like watch the games like while I was in college. So yeah, I kind of fell off, and like I used to know like all the team members, and I used to watch like a lot of games with my family, and I just don't really keep up with it anymore. I'm okay. I had an exam this morning, but I'm doing pretty good now. Now that you're done with your exam, yeah, that must be a relief. I haven't been interested in sports for a very long time. Like, I feel like I always like the idea of sports. Like, whenever I'm at a game or I'm watching a game, like, I'm always really into it. Like, I'm like paying attention. Like, I don't think I was on my phone, like, barely at all, like, the whole time we were watching the Super Bowl. It was a really exciting game, honestly. Like some games that I've seen, actually most of the football games that I've seen, are not very exciting. But this one was pretty exciting. There were some really good moments that I'm like, dang, that was really cool. Does it mean that Travis is going on tour with Taylor now, being a supportive partner during this time ruining the concerts? Like, they say Taylor's ruining football, right? Like, that whole narrative was so, like, overdone and so tiring. Yeah, I'm assuming he gets to go to more things now. Like, I don't know what, like, post-season looks like for him. He probably has to film, like, a bunch of, like, sponsorships. Like, I always know that, like, especially if you're watching the sports channel, like, you'll see, like, different, like, really big sports people, like, on all different kinds of commercials. Like they're in, like, every commercial. Like, if you are, like, the it guy in sports, and I'm sure you guys have already seen Travis in so many commercials, like, it feels like he's in, like, every other commercial you see nowadays. He's probably gonna be doing a lot of that. Travis got a fish where he started last year at the White House, right? That's true, they gotta go to the White House again. I'm so not into sports that I had to ask, were the Golden White players, right? Well, it's really confusing because, like, if you didn't know, the Chiefs and the Niners, they have very, very similar colors. They're not the exact same colors, but it's similar enough. So I think, like, there was a whole discussion, like, who was going to wear what, like, you know, like, you're going to a party with your girlfriends. You're like, well, what are you wearing? That's, like, the vibe it was giving. But yeah, sometimes I had to, like, really, like, be paying attention. I'm like, because, like, especially there was an interception and I was like, no, that's not their team member, right? Because, like, yeah, like, they're wearing the same colors basically, and I was like, that wasn't supposed to happen. I'm like, that guy's not on your team. But it threw me off for a second because it made me think. I was like, hold on a second, is he on his team? I'm like, no wait, that wasn't right. Hi Dreadful, welcome in. Just cheer when the family cheers. Yeah, like, I was like locked in, and I was like, oh my god, like, you know, me and my mom are very vocal when we watch sports, so I've always just been very vocal when I watch sports. Like, I don't know, I'm like narrating to, like, myself, and, like, I don't know, it's just like, I don't know, I get really into it. I like getting excited. I'm one of those people that if other people are excited, I get really excited. And obviously there's, like, so many people that are excited about the Super Bowl, and obviously there's so many people there being excited, and everyone's just, like, really hyped up, and everyone's, like, either hype or tense or sad or excited, and, like, I just, like, kind of, like, get those emotions, and it, like, really affects me. So, like, when everyone's all excited, I get excited, and I just like being a part of things that that other people are excited about. Like, I don't like missing out. I'm like especially if I can, like, enjoy it from the, like, the comfort of my house, which is how I've watched every Super Bowl, I think. Yeah, I don't know if I've really ever, like, maybe, like, a couple times, like, gone to somebody else's house or gone out for the Super Bowl, but, like, most of the time I'm watching it at home, so it's a home event for me. So if I can, like, get excited and, like, you know, just, like, in the comfort of my own home, that's nice. We're in a hotel, but, yeah, that was our home, like, temporarily. Like, we didn't have a choice. It's not like we could be, like, we're out of here, I don't want to watch this. Like, that's where we were sleeping, like, at the time. I know, hotel party, I wish. That's just where we were staying at the time. I don't think we watched last year's. I don't remember anything about last year's. I remember watching the halftime show, but, like, you could literally, like, yeah, I remember watching the halftime show, but, like, you could literally just pull that up on the internet after. Like, I watched Usher's performance, like, after the Super Bowl. I, like, watched it a second time. It's pretty easy to just, like, watch it, but, like, I can't remember if I watched it, honestly. Hi Becca Lise. I like watching, but when I found out there's an average ticket to the Super Bowl cost $10,000, that's crazy. Honestly, like, that's not even that crazy to me, like, because especially depending on how popular the team is and how nice the stadium is, tickets can be so expensive to any sport. Like, it's wild, and this is, like, the main game of, like, the year, and it's one of the most popular sports in the country, if not the most popular sport in the country. So, and, like, when you think that Taylor Swift tickets cost a lot, like, it's a Super Bowl, like, it only happens once. So, like, unfortunately everything's really expensive right now. I'm not sure, like, how expensive tickets have been in the past, but it's always like the Super Bowl is always held at, like, one of the nicest stadiums, like, of the time. Like, they kind of cycle through But like since the Vegas stadium is so new, it's like the newest, like, you know, nicest stadium right now. So that, yeah, they charge a lot. I'm not saying that the pricing is fair, but in comparison to like other things, like how expensive things can get, I am not surprised that it costs that much. Like, especially like with resellers and how those types of things work. It's wild. Usher's concert went through my teen years, right? I was so into it, and Ryan was like, oh, Luda's gonna show up, and like they kind of got like through like the beginning of the song, and I'm like, I kind of remember him jumping in sooner, and I was like, no, he's not gonna show up. And then when he did show up, we were like, ah. And I keep seeing so many like reaction videos where like other people are doing the same thing, like they were into yeah, but it wasn't until like Luda showed up that everyone was like, yes, Luda. It's Luda from Fast and Furious. It's the guy from Fast and Furious, guys. And he like sounds exactly the same. He sounded really good. I mean, like, I feel like they all sounded really good. And then like it took me like a hot minute to recognize her. I was like, I was looking at her like when she was doing her guitar solo, and I'm like, is that her? Like, at first I thought it was just like a regular maybe his main guitarist, but then I saw that she was mic'd up, and then like it was like it started like clicking into my head. I'm like, oh, the little sunglasses, because she always wears little sunglasses and everything. I'm like, oh my gosh, it's her. Like, it wasn't until she was like walking off the stage, I was like, that was her, wasn't it? Like, it just always takes me so long for it to click. I thought the same thing. Thank you. Yeah, sometimes it just takes me a second. I was dancing with my niece when Usher was performing and teaching my other one about Taylor Swift. You were there with the you know, you didn't know anything about the game, but you're there to educate about the music. I know, I was so excited to see her. So when I watched it again, I got like even more excited, because I went in remembering that it was her. But yeah, I was so excited to see Alicia Keys. I knew that she was gonna be there. I think someone else had already like said that she confirmed that she was gonna be there. Apparently her voice crack at the beginning has already been like edited out of like the VOD and like the performance, like the video that they've posted of their performance. But I was there live for the voice crack, and it's like, I get it. I would be really nervous too if I was performing at the Super Bowl on a weird looking piano. Like, she looked great though. I noticed the voice crack immediately, but it sounded like her voice was strange in general. Yeah, because I mean, that song was a really, you know, demanding. A lot of her songs are very demanding, so it's like I'm not surprised. There's already a meme of that pose at the end. It's so cute, the pose of like Usher and Alicia. Everyone out here thinking Jermaine Dupri was Taylor. I was just so like I felt like I was like hypnotized by the performance. So like a lot of times I wasn't even noticing when like different people were popping up and stuff like that. Like my processing was not going. And then they were like, oh, that was Will.i.am. And I was all like, I don't know. Like, I'm not surprised. I'm like, I believe you. I was like, to me, it was just some dude in a mask. And it's like, it had been so long since I had like perceived Will.i.am. I like just didn't even really think about it. And I was like, yeah, you could have told me anyone was in that performance and I would believe you, because I was just like, yeah, I was hypnotized by Usher, and I was just like, what's going on? And I'm like listening for the next song and everything. So I just said he looked like Boss Baby in his little outfit. Yeah, because it was kind of like a suit, but like with shorts. I get that. He did kind of look like Boss Baby now that I think about it. But yeah, I thought Usher did really, really well. It was probably like one of my favorite Super Bowl commercials. Not like the favorite, because like, I don't know, there's like a lot of really good ones. But like, I don't know, it was really fun. Like, I felt like I was having a good time like the whole time. Like some Super Bowl ones, I'm just like, it's not as like, I think it's because Usher makes like dancing club music that like it just felt like it was the right vibes. Like some Super Bowl performances, I feel like, yeah, they're kind of like, as like the Weeknd's one, that one was probably the most boring one in like recent history. I'm like, what am I supposed to do with the Weeknd's music? Like, I like his music in general, but like lately I feel like I've been skipping his music. Like if it pops up like as I'm playing other music, I'm like, nah, skip. Like, I don't know, it's just he doesn't like really, like his music doesn't really excite me. Some of his music did, like maybe like a few years ago, but maybe I'm just kind of over it. I made a joke about how at Filipino parties the aunties would see one of the kids dancing and like Usher would say, why is he so hyperactive, right? He like never stopped dancing, he was like going the whole time. When Usher started taking his shirt off, my 4-year-old niece stopped and stared, and I was like, hey, you gotta cut that out, your dad's right. Oh my gosh, that was so, like, when the Janet Jackson thing happened, if you don't know what it is, don't worry about it. But like, I was like in the other room playing with my family, or playing with my cousins, and my mom called me over because I used to love Justin Timberlake and especially that song, and Janet Jackson obviously. And she's like, oh my gosh, like, you know, she, my daughter, you know, she's so excited, she loves this. And I'm like, oh yeah, I do, cool. And I was like, you know, into the next room, I don't really care, like, I like the song, but I'm not gonna watch a football game. And apparently, like, right after I walked out of the room was when the incident happened. And I was like, oh, like, my mom was like, God, I just told them that you really liked them. And then they went and embarrassed you like that. I'm like, embarrassed me? I think they embarrassed themselves. The Janet Jackson moment changed my life for real. I didn't even see it, but somehow it's like, anytime it gets brought up, my mom always mentions, like, yeah, I had just told them that, like, they were like, that you love them so much and that they make really good music. And then they did something, like, so, like, unexpected in the whole room. Like, it was like, I think my grandparents were there, and then, like, my parents, and then, like, my dad's siblings. So it was like all older people, and they were just like, whoa, whoa. I know what happened. I think I missed the exact moment. Yeah, I definitely didn't see the exact moment. I mean, I've seen it since, but, like, honestly, I don't even think I've seen, like, the actual thing in subject, but I've seen, like, the moment leading up to it, and then, yeah, you know what I mean. I was watching, I turned or did something and blink, right? It's like one of those things where you turn and blink and it's over. Hold on, my heater's, like, really high. It's hot. Okay, I could feel it, like, starting to, like, really warm up my back because I have it right behind me. I was like, I gotta turn that off. But I'm sure I'll be cold in, like, a couple minutes and want to turn it back on. I kind of like, though, just, like, warming up this little space that I'm in and then, like, changing it back to cool. Like, I don't really like the heater being, like, on me constantly. I just feel like it's just a bit much, especially with my PC, like, especially when I'm playing The Sims with, like, a bajillion mods and CC, my computer gets plenty hot. But yeah, I've definitely paused on, like, the modding and stuff like that because of all of the crap that's been going on. But yeah, if you're a simmer and you mod your game, if you didn't know, like, a couple of creators or mods were, like, compromised, and this is mainly on, like main sites, so, like, Mod The Sims, The Sims Resource, and Curse Forge. I think I saw that people's mods were getting messed up, and I don't download mods through those sites, like, ever. Like, I don't think I ever have. Maybe Mod The Sims, like, I think only some mods are on there, but I haven't updated them, like, in recent weeks. I think this has been happening. But yeah, I always download mods directly from the creator, like, either through their, like, specific website, like, Twisted Mexi has a specific website, and then, or through Patreon, where it's, like, they're uploading it themselves, it's their files, it's not going through, like, some random place where someone can, like, jump in. How are they getting compromised? How? I don't know. I'm not sure what you mean by how. I don't know the how. But they're, like, running, like, when you download the mod and you run your game and you run the mods, it's, like, running an extra file. I don't know what it is or what it does, but obviously it shouldn't be in there. Like, it's a file that shouldn't be in there. And I think it's what's happening is that people are, like, impersonating these modders and going and uploading, like, compromised versions of the mods. And people are downloading them thinking it's from the original creator, but it's not. And then it's just getting messed up. Malware. Yeah, these words don't mean anything to me. But just be careful as you're out there. Do your research. A couple people have posted a couple things in the Discord. Again, I'm just, like, not really downloading mods or updating my mods, like, the last couple weeks that this has been happening. But again, like, I don't download from these sites that are being messed up. So I think just, you know, just be really careful, like, how usual, just, you know, do your research, make sure you're only getting mods from, like, specific places that you trust. It was just how I've always been with mods. I've always been nervous about modding because things like this can happen. And this hasn't happened, like, in a while. Like, since I've been modding something, like, where it's been multiple modders and multiple different mods that have been messed up, like, I don't think this has happened in recent years. So, I'm not sure exactly, like, how they've gone about to, like, impersonate these modders and, like, trick people. So just, you know, just be careful. There's a lot of lists going on social media and, like, Discord and, like, all of the, like, there's a lot of, what are they called, like there's a lot of Discords out there that like help people with their games, like, you know, like, oh, if your game is broken or something like that, there's like a lot of information going around. If you haven't seen it yet, feel free to like message me and I can try to send you some resources. I don't have anything open in front of me, so I'm just kind of saying what I've heard. Mal malicious, yeah, it's bad. Mal is bad. people are such losers. I know what malicious, like, malware means. I just mean, like, I don't know how to explain it, so that's why I didn't use that word. Like, using words that don't mean, like, I don't, like, you know what I mean? Like, I knew what malware means and malicious. But just that, like, using that word wouldn't have added any context for me, but if it means anything to you, go ahead. People are such losers, like, get a job or hobby. Apparently this is their hobby, just to mess with people and to, like, I don't know, like, again, like, I don't know what the extra file is doing that it's running. The worst case is that, you know, it's doing something to your computer or taking information from your computer and sending it to the person who did this. But those are like worst case scenarios. I'm not sure. I don't know. But yeah, I probably shouldn't have brought it up. Now I feel stupid. I don't know why all of a sudden I'm like all self-conscious about it. This is why I don't like talking about things when I feel like I don't know like all the information. But like, I don't know. I just like, I don't know. I feel bad now. Like, I feel like you guys think I'm stupid. But yeah, like, I don't like, I'm trying to not stop myself from like trying to speak freely. But like, I don't know. Sometimes when I speak freely, I feel like I get like I feel like I'm like I'm not explaining things well, or I feel like stupid. I'm like, maybe I should just like shut up. No, you're not stupid. I hope not. I've gone most of my life thinking that I'm not stupid. But yeah, you can see like I'm starting to get embarrassed. My ears are getting red and stuff. Thank you for the follow. I hope you're having a great day. It's alright if you don't know all the things about modding your files or things like that. It's confusing. It's like one of those things. It's like, ask me how my phone works. I don't know. Like, in general, like, I guess I could know, but I could never explain it to somebody. Oh, there's like a bug on my monitor. If I had to explain it to somebody, like, using intelligent wording and like full thought out sentences, I couldn't do it. And it's like, it's just like, yeah, it's one of those things. And like, yeah, I don't know. I just get easily embarrassed, especially like, I don't know. I feel like I've been having, like, this weekend was a really busy weekend for me. Like, lots of different social interactions with like a lot of different people. And I just feel like my, because like, you know, I feel like I have like, I don't know, this is like a made up number, but I feel like I have like a 10% chance of doing something embarrassing at like any given moment. And it's like, the more social interactions I have, or the more time I spend socializing, you know, the 10%, you know, gets multiplied by like, you know, the 10 social interactions that I've had. And then like, and then I'm like doing embarrassing shit all over the place. So it's like I just feel like I'm like definitely my social battery is like definitely drains. Like, I feel like I'm on like fumes right now of social battery. But like, honestly, like when I'm streaming though, that doesn't usually affect me. Like, I feel like it's almost like having a dinner stomach and like a dessert stomach. Like, I feel like my social battery for streaming is like different than my social battery for in like real life. But even then, I'm just like, yeah, like sometimes like I feel like the emotions will carry over. And I think because I'm like in such a like high alert, like nervous energy from this weekend, because I feel like, oh my gosh, I'm like so embarrassing, I do so many embarrassing things, I'm like bringing that into here. So sorry if I'm like extra sensitive or something like that. That's just how it is. I'm a sensitive person in general, but I think I have thicker skin most of the time. But yeah, I feel like because my social battery is so low, my thicker skin is like not there. And I honestly think I'm lying. No, never mind, I'm a liar. I don't have thick skin. Never mind. I don't know why I lied to you guys. I don't know why I said that. I definitely don't have thick skin. I am a very sensitive person. I've definitely cried on stream before. I've cried on stream multiple times. I've cried in real life multiple times. I cry, like, I probably cry, like, or at least tear up, like, once a day. I was gonna say, I'm super drained, like just socially in general. What's my zodiac? I'm a Taurus. And before people say like, oh, I like you, and I don't usually like Tauruses, it's not a compliment. Every time I tell someone I'm a Taurus, I always have to like steel myself with the fact they're like, really, you're a Taurus? I usually hate Tauruses, but you're okay. So keep it to yourself. I know you guys don't like us. I'm sorry. And I'm a double Taurus. I always forget. I'm like a sun and a rising. I don't know. I have a note. I haven't looked at it in a while. Taurus or Taurus? Lately, I have not been traveling, so just a Taurus. But if I was also traveling, then I would be a Taurus as well. Where's my thing? Yeah, I'm a sun. My Taurus is sun. My moon is Leo, and then I'm also a rising Taurus, so I'm a double one. So my besties are Tauruses. Thank you. Finally, a Taurus lover. Thank you. Most people are like, I don't have any Taurus friends because I don't like them, but you're my friend, so that's okay. And I'm like, that doesn't make me feel great. Taurus, tortoise. Yes, call me a tortoise. Honestly, like, I feel like my zodiac sign should be like a tortoise, but I'm a dog. My zodiac is a dog. I don't even, what's this year? Is it dragon? I feel like I keep seeing dragons. It was literally just Lunar New Year, so I should know. I think it is dragon this year, right? Chinese zodiac years. Double trouble, literally. I am, especially if we're counting Taurus. It's the dragon year. Thank you. Last year was rabbit, right? I can never remember. I don't ask what people's signs are. Like, sometimes I'll ask if I'm curious, but I honestly don't know other signs. Like, I know mine, and I kind of like maybe like know little bits about other people's signs, but like some people will know. They're like, oh my gosh, like, what's you and your significant other's like signs? And then they'll be like, oh my gosh, that means this, and they'll like tell you all the different things about how those two signs interact. And they'll even know like if you're moon, sun, and rising, and they could tell you what that combo means. And I'm like, that's a lot of knowledge. I don't know if I've known that many things. like I don't know, how many horoscope signs, there we go. I'm like, I always forget how many horoscope signs are there. There's like so many, and then to like remember everything. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Is that right? 8 of them? I'm like, that's a lot to remember. Like, how you, oh, 12. There we go. 12. Sorry, I was looking at a list and it was cut off at the bottom. And I'm like, I imagine knowing that and then knowing like all of the like combos and like what they mean. Apparently me and Mr. Meavy have signs with perfect compatibility. I feel it. Apparently Ryan was warned very early on that our signs are not compatible. I think mine is Earth and his is, I don't remember. I think he's a Sagittarius. What is it? I just put Sagittarius in, but it's just telling me the dates. What kind is it? We're both archers. Oh, that's cute. Type? It's a fire. Yeah, so Ryan's fire and I'm earth, so I don't think that works very well. From what I've been told. Yeah, no one's asked me recently, but I think one of Ryan's like teachers or something like that asked him in college. Me and Ryan, not Miss. Me and Mr. Meavy. Me and Ryan, not me and Mr. Meavy. I don't know if I know what your message means. I'm so sorry. Mr. Meavy is air and I'm fire. Oh, I see. Sorry, I was like, what? Me and Meavy are archers because we're both Sagittarius. Okay, sorry. I thought you meant you and Mr. Meavy are archers. Sorry. I'm like, sometimes when messages don't have enough context, my brain like will just randomize the connection. Like, it's not, sometimes it doesn't even make sense. It'll just be like, what's the last thing I remember saying, or what's the previous message, and I'll just kind of like roll a dice and try to guess what it means. And most of the time I'm completely off. If you've hung out here for any amount of time, my brain's not great at remembering what we were literally just talking about. But yeah, today's probably not going to be a very long stream. I already feel very uncomfortable. I don't know why. I feel very like embarrassed and very like raw right now. So I don't know. I don't know what it is. I'm sorry if the vibes are off. I might just cry and end stream. We'll see. Hi there, Catherine. Been a while since I made it to stream. Happy to be back. Oh my gosh, I'm glad you're back too. I hope you're having a great day. I'm a crab. Oh my gosh, that little crab is so cute. They're doing a little dancey dance. Yes, welcome in. All right, so this is my girl. She's sleeping. I feel like every time we open our game, she's sleeping. But I think it's just because I'm always like, okay, she's asleep. It's the end of the day. Let's end stream. Let's like close up the game. But yeah, let me check how she is. Yeah, we're on level 3 out of 4 of the Chief of Mischief aspiration. So the last thing we need to do for at least this stage is get to level 10 mischief, which is also something we need to do just for the rules in general. We do need to get level 10 mischief skills. people. This is something that I just checked, so it's always good to check the rules more than once. So I think, yeah, the one thing that I forgot about for the mint gen is we need to get the mischief to level 10, and we need to get logic, I think, also to level 10, which we're level 6, so not too bad. We'll get there. I feel like she gets there anyway when she's at work, but if we need to, like, give her a boost, we can do that. Oh, maybe we have enough for it within the club that we have. Sorry, I have something blocking my monitor. Oh yeah, we don't have enough. I think we need like 500 or something like that to get like a logic boost. Where is it? What's a logic sign? I don't even know. Is it like chess? Is it this one? Logic boost. Yeah, it's 400. So we need a lot more. excuse me. Fire needs air, and air doesn't need fire. It just makes things exciting, which actually relates to our relationship. I can't even really think about the elemental logic behind, like, what earth and fire mean together. Like, I don't think my brain can, like, conceptualize, like, how they work or don't work together. Like, but that makes sense for fire and air. You were able to logic yourself right into that. But I probably have to look it up and just see what other people say, because I don't know. If someone wants to make it up, I'd probably believe you. I actually don't eat that. Let's have some actual breakfast. Yeah, let's just have normal breakfast. Oh, but they're both awake. Okay. Here, let's start a gathering then. So that way we can have the bonuses. All right, where are you going? Actually, yeah, you're fine. Do we need to have any more breakthroughs? No, we have the breakthroughs, so we just need to get the promotion, which I think we didn't get a promotion at the end of last stream, and I was kind of like, what the heck, how come we didn't get a promotion? I was a little annoyed. Earth, wind, and fire, we make a government. There we go, perfect. That's all I need to know. Like, if there was a song, like, maybe there is, like, kind of like that helps, like, you, like, remember these things, that'd be nice. I've always been, like, really good with, like, associations. Like, like, if I, like, I think when I was trying to learn the, oh gosh, what is it? Like, the Order of the Presidents, I think there's, like, a song for it. Oh, no, it was, there's a song for the states and their capitals, I think. that always helps when there's something like that. Did I get any new elements? Did we send stuff to get new elements back? I'm just gonna check from here. Because it's easier than using the board. I thought the board was really going to help me, but it's more confusing than anything. Yeah, I'm still missing two. So even though we got some in the mail, I'm just going to put them away. I've been keeping, like, more crystals and metals in our pocket, though, because we need them for, like, experiments at our job. So, and I kept sending them off to get looked at, and we never had any. So I've learned. All right. What can we do while we wait then? I guess we can work on our mischief skill. Yeah, I guess we can just go troll the forums. Troll, please. There we go. Yeah, she doesn't have work until 10, but her waking up at 3 is already throwing me off, because that means she's probably going to be tired, like, right when she goes to work. Do we have any laundry going? Should we run laundry? No, actually, our laundry basket looks fine. I also still haven't fixed the scroller ball on my mouse, even though I complain about it literally all the time. Still haven't fixed it. It's just one of those things where it's like, once I walk away from my computer, like, I'm not even thinking about it anymore. So then I don't bother to do anything about it. Let me see. Why me contemplating life? Oh, yeah, he is having a midlife crisis. I forgot. Let me see. Yeah, midlife crisis. Brag 15 times, put money into a vault. We're not doing that. There's only big vault. If we had smaller vault, I would do that. Win a competition or a game or go to work focus. I might be able to get him focused. I think we have something that I could do to do that. See you soon, you student. Welcome in, Emmy Games. Welcome in, Raiders. Emmy Clan is here to raid. Hooray! Thank you so much for the raid. How was your stream? Ooh, how was Stardew? I hope you guys had an amazing time playing Stardew. If you're new here, hello. I'm May. I use she, her pronouns. I'm a Mexican Filipino streamer. And we're playing some Not So Berry today. We have our mint gen sim working on her mischief skill, because we need to get it to level 10. So that's what she's working on. She did recently get engaged to her fiance. This is her fiance. And yeah, they just did recently get engaged after a pretty, I don't know, like, the best way I can describe it is, like, a little bit of a toxic time together. But he almost died. So I think He was doing laundry and the dryer caught on fire and he almost died. But so I think he's like, he's mellowed out a little bit after his near death experience. So we're gonna see if that's still true. Stardew was fun. Coop Farm year one. Oh my gosh, year one summer, how nice. It's always so fun, like year one. I feel like year one is like such a fun grindy time in the game. Thank you again though, Emmy, for the raid. If you guys didn't already know Emmy Games before the raid, make sure to check them out. And again, I don't think I've actually said this, so I can't say and again, but we're a very lurker friendly community. So if anyone needs to lurk, I totally understand. Feel free to do whatever makes you more comfortable. Feel free to chat as much as you want, lurk as much as you want. Anything goes here. Let me snooze these ads. Yes, I agree, right? I feel like sometimes I feel like I never finish my farms in Stardew because I just like early game a lot, you know? All right, he does need to work on a painting before work. So honestly, I don't really pay attention too much. Oh no, wait, he doesn't do this anymore. He used to be a painter, but he had a midlife crisis, so he switched his job. So he has to browse intelligence. Maybe I should get rid of his painting thing. Or I guess now that can just be a what's it called? Like a hobby, like an actual hobby. Maybe he didn't like, you know, what's it called? What's the phrase I'm looking for? Like making his like something that he liked his job, you know what I mean? So maybe we'll keep painting as a hobby, but now spying will be his job. The house is so cozy. Oh, thank you so much. Year one started, he was elite. I agree. Seriously, right? I agree. All right, are you just sitting there? She is just sitting there. There's something I can always just tell. When my Sims aren't doing what they're supposed to do. I think it's just my history of doing 100 baby challenge. I just know when a Sim is sitting around, not working on whatever they're supposed to be working on. What time does he go to work? He goes to work at 7 a.m. So like pretty early in the day. She doesn't go to work until 10. But yeah, he just switched careers. So yeah, he's still level one in his career, but she's level 7. Because we've been working on that for a little bit. And I hope she gets a promotion today since she's had the 14 breakthroughs that she needs. If I remember, let me go ahead and go downstairs actually and set up the focus mood. So hopefully she at least like kind of has that basis for being focused. And hopefully that means, oh man, she just broke the computer. should I have him fix it or her fix it? I'll probably have her fix it, honestly. I don't think that helps with any of the skills that I needed to work on, but can't hurt to have her do it. Oh, I haven't unmuted my game. My bad. All right, let me set this up. Repair. There we go. All right, let me go ahead and take my break. We do have ads coming, so I might as well just take one now. I need to run to the restroom. But yeah, if you guys need to take care of yourself too, do a little bit of self-care. The ads will be about 3 minutes long. So feel free to do whatever you need to do. I'm going to run to the restroom, and I'll see you guys in a little bit. Here's some hard jellies if you guys want to gamble, and I'll see you guys in a little bit. Bye! Welcome back. The song reminds me, it's Beyonce, by the way, that I think Beyonce has a Twitch account now. Thank you for welcoming me back. Sorry if your what's it called? Your gambles didn't go very well. I think it's like Slayonce or something like that. Slayonce. Let's see. No, it's Playonce. There we go. I am Slayonce. Shout out, I am Slayonce. One second. Oh, not raid. Oh, that would have been bad. Never trust me to mod for myself. But yeah, if you guys didn't see, I think they showed it twice, Beyonce Super Bowl commercial. There's like a part of it where she's like streaming. So I know a lot of streamer friends were really excited about that. I think there was like one other commercial. I can't remember, but I feel like there was one other commercial that showed streaming or someone like streaming on like Twitch or like a Twitch like site, but I can't remember what the commercial was. But yeah, Slayonce. I just followed her. All right, let's see. What were we going to do? We were going to fix our laptop, but after we make sure that we're in a nice focused mood. Oh, he just blew us a kiss. That was sweet. All right, where are we going? I guess we're just going to chat here for a little bit. That's fine. They don't really get to spend a whole lot of days together or time together, I mean. I did remember to finally remove her leg hair because I kept forgetting about it and I kept like... like thinking it was a glitch in like her skin or something like that, but no, it was like mint leg hair. So I finally remembered to take that off. Like, I'm glad that they gave us like body hair and like hair that like grows and stuff like that. I just don't ever use it. I don't know, it's just not something that I use in my everyday gameplay. I did give him, though, you can't see it obviously because he's got like clothes on. Actually, I don't know if many of his outfits will show up, but I did give him arm hair and leg hair because I hadn't done that. And I thought it would look kind of cool on him. Yeah, I think this works on what skill? Handiness skill. But yeah, we do need to work on her logic skill a little bit more because I didn't realize that that was also part of the mint gen. All right, you going to work, right? No, you're going to go grill. Did you... Okay, now you're going to work. Did he finish what he was supposed to finish? Yeah, so he browsed intelligence, so he might get a promotion. All right, what are you doing? You're done? Good job. Let's see. Let's take care of your needs before you have to go to work in a little bit. Get you some breakfast and all that good stuff. Oh, I didn't mean to speed you up. My bad. Hi, Violet Lucy. How are you? I'm doing good. It's good to see you. Let me see, where's the other quick meal thing? There it is. I couldn't find it for the life of me. Yeah, having a pretty good day. We went on a walk earlier and it wasn't raining when I was getting ready for the walk, but then it started drizzling like well, as we were coming out the door. It might have been drizzling for a while, I just couldn't tell, but like as we walked out the door we were like, might as well just do our walk. So we had like a little bit of a shorter walk, but yeah, it was like in the rain, so like I feel like my hair like looks all like interesting because it like got wet and like dried funny. But I'm also planning on washing my hair tonight, so I'm really not worried about it. What else? I am still reading my book. I finished House of Flame and Shadow, but now I'm reading Kingdom of Ash. So that's what I'm reading right now. It's like a 1,000-page book. And I've been trying to finish it for like a bajillion years. So like I think this whole year, actually, I think like I forget when I started. I started it last year, like in 2023. And I like kept starting it and putting it down and starting it and putting it down. And like I would reread the part that I already read to try to get like into it. And then eventually I'm like, I need, like, if I'm going to keep putting this book, like, if I'm going to keep picking up and putting this down this book, I'm just going to have to find like a recap. And I could not find like a recap like anywhere. I found like this one random blog where someone like would do very like minimal recaps of every chapter, and I'm like, okay, this is enough to at least like spur my memory. That sounds so fun. Yeah, it was nice. I'm good, thank you. It's 3 a.m here in the UK. Woke up 2 hours ago after falling asleep at 8 p.m going to try to get back to sleep for a couple more hours before work. Yeah, if you're able to, like, if you're able to go back to sleep after you wake up, that's awesome. I'm like, I'm definitely not one of those people. Like, unless I'm really, really tired, like, kind of once I wake up, I stay awake, unfortunately. And we were just talking about earlier in stream how I feel like I haven't slept very well, like, this whole, like, past week. Like, I want to say, like, the last time I got good sleep was, like, Wednesday or Thursday, and it's, like, about to be Tuesday. And, like, yeah, I just haven't been sleeping well. Oh, shoot, we haven't paid our bills. Hold on, I gotta pay our bills. Where is that again? Show bill information. I thought there was a way to just pay bills. Is there not just like a pay bills? Do I have the bill in my pocket? Where is it? Oh, there it is. Pay bills. There we go. Let's not get our energy turned off or anything. Yeah, honestly, I knew I shouldn't have fallen asleep so early, but I was so dang sleepy. Yeah, some people, like my husband's, he's able to take like a nap at like 10 p.m. and then still go to sleep like fine at midnight. For me, like if I mess up my sleep schedule, like I am screwed. Like, there's no recovering from that. I am just gonna be messed up for like forever. And yeah, like usually, yeah, once I'm awake, unless I'm really tired. Like sometimes I'll get up to use like the restroom in the middle of the night, and I'm able to go to sleep after that. But like if I'm awake and it's like about to be sunrise or it's already sunrise, like there's no going back to sleep for me. I hate that for you. I hope you sort out your sleep soon. I have also had issues with sleep lately. Must be something to do in retrograde. I always blame it on retrograde. I'm always down for that. I love having an excuse. I always blame astrology, right? I love having an excuse. I'm like, oh, it's not my fault. It's the planets. Couldn't be my fault. I'm perfect. Welcome back, new pseudonym. Sleeping is my hobby. Today was my day off, and I spent all day in bed. Oh my gosh, I'm so happy for you. That honestly sounds like heaven. I need to get on your level. The speed run to the bathroom for a pee so I don't lose the sleepiness, right? You're like, if I'm up too much, I won't be able to go back to sleep. Like, I have to like trick my body to like really be slow, like not turn on all the lights and everything like that, like, you know, just like stealth, you know, make sure my body doesn't realize that we're awake. Yeah, it's really hard to fall asleep when it's already getting light out. Yeah, once like it hits like, I don't know, I want to say like 5 a.m it's done with for me. Like, if I'm awake, right? I love that for you. Like, I was hoping I could sleep in this morning, but like I woke up at like I was trying to give myself permission to like sleep in a lot. Like, I was like, you know, I could sleep in until like even like 11, because I feel like I'm so behind on sleep. Like, I want to say like in the past like few days, I feel like I've only gotten like, I don't know, like 15 hours of sleep like since Thursday. I'm like, that is not good. Like, just a lot of tossing and turning. Like, I'm down and I'm like kind of sleepy and I feel like I'm kind of asleep, but not really, you know? So like, I feel like I've only gotten like a decent amount of like deep sleep, you know? So I wanted to sleep in this morning, but like I woke up at like 9:10-ish and I just couldn't go back to sleep. So I kind of just tried to lay there to like kind of get my body some rest, but like I don't think it worked. Gotta hobble to the toilet with my eyes half closed. I swear, I feel like I'm like, if I could get there with my eyes closed, I would try, but I'm too clumsy for that. I know, I need more sleep. Do you recommend this challenge, by the way? I struggle with so much with sticking to gameplay with The Sims, and I really want to do some fun sim challenges to play. This is my first time doing Not So Berry, and I really like it so far. I've done other challenges. I've done Black Widow and 100 Baby, and I really, really like those. This one's really fun. It's a lot slower, but like I like that there's like quests, basically. I call them quests. Quests that you have to do, you know, there's rules. But so far I'm really liking it. I love watching people play Not So Berry, so I'm like, eventually I knew I was gonna do it. But I'm having a good time with it. Yeah, like drifty sleep. Yeah, like structured quests. I love a good structured quest. That is my jam. It's raining. Rain. Gross. I never play the science career, so I might try. Yeah, this is my first time playing the science career, and I don't know if there's a way to do it nicely. It seems like I am the worst person. It seems like I am just here to really bully my coworkers. So I don't know if there's a way to play the science career nice. So if you feel bad like being mean to other people or even other Sims, I feel like the Not So Berry challenge might be rough for you, because I think there are, yeah, because you have to be mischievous as well in this gen. So you're like, and you have to get people to despise you. Like, it hurts me because like I'm one of those people where I'll try to do like an evil run in a game and I'll change my mind part of the way through because I hate being mean to people. Like, sometimes, you know, I'm in the mood for, like, a fight, you know? I'm like, yeah, this is great. Like, I love the drama. I love, you know, some like, wild times, some chaotic times. But, like, I don't know, when it really comes down to it, it's hard to be mean to people. And in Wenjin, you have to dump someone at the altar. Yeah, there's, I remember looking through the friggin' rules, and there are a couple, like, and you have to be a criminal for one of them. Hubby just got home from work. I'm gonna run. Have a good time with your hubby. All right, so we mixed a tainted serum. Browse the web on the computer. I would love to. I feel like he's on the way for the computer, but let's see if I can intercept, because I want to use the computer. I have a mod that changes the hours for the science career to the graveyard shift. It's so weird to see the lab in the daylight. Yeah, and this is also not my lab. I think this one's by Simsy. I figured she would know a good layout for it, because I remember people saying that the original lab is, like, very badly, like, organized, so it's hard to get everything done. And since Simsy made the Not So Berry challenge, I figured her lab would be perfect. So that's the one that I'm using. Oh god, honestly, I hate playing The Sims with a horrible sim, but it would be a good challenge for me. I think definitely doing Black Widow challenge, I think, helped me a little bit, because, no one's gonna be worse than your Black Widow sim, right? Like, they're the worst. let me see. Oh, okay, done with that. Yeah, I meant to say this, that is the original lab. There's barely anything I see different. Oh, really? I'm gonna make my first gen sim now. Thank you for the inspo. I won't be sleeping more today. No, don't tell me that. You should get some sleep. But if you don't, and it's because of The Sims, that's not a bad way to go. I can't figure out what she might have changed. Really? Okay, so maybe it's not any different. I don't know. I didn't even really get a chance to play with the old one before I switched it over. Drink or give away tainted serum. Who should I give it away to? Maybe. There's, like, one of them. One of my coworkers that doesn't like me. We accidentally did kill one coworker, though. He is set on fire after we tested a serum on him. Oh, do they all like me again? No, you don't like me. Okay. Can you take my tainted serum? I'm not going to ask you to be a part of my wedding. No, thank you. I have so many tainted serums. I think it's because I cloned one of them. All right, let's give the tainted serum to this one that doesn't like me. What's your name again? Tim. We did have a crush on one of our coworkers, but then she got married to Don Lothario, and I should check if she's pregnant still. She was pregnant earlier. All right, let's see if he dies. Hopefully not, because I already accidentally killed one of my coworkers. He, like, internally combusted. It was really, oh, he's just gonna pass out. That's fine. Just don't die. Yeah, not bad. I'm only working 11 to 3, so I should be okay, hopefully. Oh, that's not too bad. Yeah, when I used to work half shifts, I honestly had a lot of fun. I liked working half shifts. Work on the treadmill for 30 minutes. Yeah, let's do that. And then let me see if our coworker is still pregnant. Oh, no, it looks like she gave birth. Hold on, I'm kind of curious. How do you check again? She has 3 kids? What? When did you have 3 kids? Where do you check that again? List children? June, Lionel, and Quinn. 3? Yeah, I accidentally made a sleeping potion. Hi, Midwest Cowgirl. How are you doing? It's good to see you again. I know she had, I don't know if those are all at once. We'll have to go to her house and check it out. I think she's living with, like, the Calientes and stuff. So we'll have to go visit. But yeah, her birthday is coming. Oh, shoot. It's today. I thought it was tomorrow. Okay. We have to do something for our birthday. I totally forgot. I thought we had, for some reason, I remember her birthday being in the middle of the week, but I thought we were on Monday. I think it's just because when we started the stream, my brain automatically went to Monday, because I'm like, beginning of the stream, beginning of the week. But no, her birthday is today. So, I'll try to remember to do something for her birthday. Otherwise, the sim is going to be so sad. And that would be so, like, anticlimactic for, like, my first gen sim to, like, not have a birthday thing. I'm okay. Work was rough. I'm so sorry work was rough. Hopefully your day's looking better. I love a little baby shift. I picked one up today because it's half term in the UK, so it's busy at my work, but the money will be so worth it. True. Yeah, it's like one of those things where you're like, you know, I don't really want to, but it's probably a good idea. How are you? I'm good. I'm a little sleepy, but I'm good. Are you excited for the Sims free update today? Oh yeah, tomorrow for me. Yeah. Yeah, it looks like it's gonna be Vitiligo, and I think hopefully some other skin details. I'm kind of excited, like, especially if you don't have CC. I don't think there's any vitiligo in the game, so that'll be really nice. Give a sim a synthetic food. Oh, the one that I was gonna give it to, he's already passed out. Let's try to give it to him. Serum. Test serum, a synthetic food. Let's do that one. Good thing I have all these already made. Finally adding vitiligo. That's what it seemed like from the teaser. So there was a teaser on socials and it was literally just like feet like walking by. But I think that's what the teaser was trying to say. Just how little I'm paying attention. I haven't been paying attention much either. So, oh, did he die? There's ash right here. Did someone die? Did he combust? Okay, hold on. We're testing another serum. Let's make sure that this guy doesn't die. Okay, I think he's fine. But where'd our other coworker go? Oh, there he is. Oh god, I thought you busted into flames because I saw this thing of ash here. Oh no, that would have been bad. We've already done that once. Yeah, I saw it on Reddit earlier. Okay. I'm here for new skin details, right? Yeah, especially if you don't use mods or CC. I feel like the game doesn't have much skin details otherwise. Converse about aliens. Maybe we should talk to the coworker. I think she's technically one of the coworkers that we're close to. We were kind of close to our coworker that died by fire. I guess it was technically our fault. look at your relationship to see if he's a ghost. He's not. He's right there. He's sad, but he's not a ghost, you know? Yeah, he's alive. Aw, look at them hugging. But yeah, maybe it's because I accidentally gave him a sleeping potion. He's a little pissed off. I never pay attention anymore, though. It feels like there's a new Sims content overload sometimes with the kids. Yeah, and I swear, like, I did take a break from Sims for, like, a good amount of time because... Shit, you're stuck in the desk. She, like, because I felt like there were, like, patches and updates, like, every week. And I was like, I'm so tired of updating my freaking mods. So I just kind of stopped playing for a little bit. And that's kind of how I am with Palia right now, too, because I'm in their Discord and I haven't even updated my game yet for the new market. I've been meaning to play, but, like, I keep seeing, like, on Discord that they're having, like, bugs and issues. And, like, I'm like, well, I'll just do something else. Okay, so we can read a book, we can calibrate the electroflux wormhole generator. I feel like we'll do that. Yeah, we'll calibrate the wormhole generator. And then maybe we can do the serum. I'm new to your Twitch. Welcome in, Addison. Nice to meet you. It's nice to meet you too. I hope you're having a good one. Talking of CC, warning to anyone who uses it, there's a few mods on the Sims Resource Course Forge at the moment that malware. There's a post on Reddit about it. Please scan your device to see any CC from those places, guys. Yeah, it's been the last couple weeks. So if you've gotten, there's a specific list of mods. I don't have it on top of my brain right now. A couple people did post it in our Discord, and it's literally anywhere. If you like look up like Sims mod malware, there's like 5 or 6 mods that are affected from specific creators. So it's not everything. You don't have to necessarily worry about everything, but in the meantime, like, if you can avoid it, maybe don't download any new mods or CC. And if you are, get it directly from like the person's like website or Patreon. Maybe don't get it through CurseForge or the Sims Resource. I hardly ever shop on the Sims Resource and I don't use CurseForge, so thankfully my computer is safe. But yeah, if you get it, I think there are a couple ones on Mod the Sims too that might be affected. We were talking about this earlier, and I would Google it to make sure you're getting the most up-to-date information, because I don't want to give you guys the wrong information. But yeah, welcome in, Asin. Welcome in. All right, what can we do next? Mind control a sim to clean, read a book, or mix simify serum. I think, are there books? Yeah, there's books right here. We'll just read a book. Maybe that'll help us get into the focus mood again. I find it slightly ironic, wasn't Curse Forge promoting themselves as being safer, right? And I was already sussed out. I always, anytime anyone brought them up, I'm like, I don't know. I don't know about that. But I didn't really have any like basis for it besides being a natural hater that I am. But now we have proof that it is a little sussy. It sucks because I installed CurseForge recently thinking it would be super easy to install mods now. Yeah, I feel like I was kind of like recommending it to people who were like new to modding. I'm like, yeah, maybe it's a good place to start. But since I'm kind of used to like my own routine of getting mods and stuff like that, I was like, I'll just keep kind of doing it the way I've been doing it. And I guess me being a hater saved me from potentially downloading malware. So, you know, sometimes being a hater is good. Yeah, it was a big reason I installed it. Yeah, I've never used it, but I feel like that's kind of what the purpose was for it, is to be safer and easier to download mods. But unfortunately, he did get promoted. He is now intelligence researcher. He makes two more simoleons per hour for 19 simoleons per hour. He got a bonus, the Swiveler, which maybe is a chair. And then he gets to do intelligence research on the computer. Okay, she's focused. Great. Let's see. Give an untested serum to a coworker. I don't think I have an untested one. Here, maybe we'll just make him clean. That's an easy one to do. I only use two mods, UI cheats and MCC, so I decided not to get it. Yeah, and those ones you can get directly from Weber Sue's Patreon/MCC Command Center's, like, their Patreon, so you don't really have to like use any other spot or any other like outside tool for that. It's so scary because it's embedded into the Sims 4 files too, so it wouldn't run until you launch the game, and hence your PC wouldn't pick up on it until it's too late. I still love CC though. Have an addiction, I swear. Yeah, I was like really worried about doing CC and mods for a really long time. Like, I've only been using mods and CC for like 3 years, because it always made me nervous, so I feel like I always err on the side of caution anyway. But yeah, if you're worried, you know, just err on the side of caution, or just maybe take a break from modding for like a little bit. Twisted Mexi did make a new mod that I think helps detect like the bad stuff, so if you're worried about it, maybe try that too. And Twisted Mexi, we trust. He's honestly amazing. I'm going to head to bed. Hope you have a good stream. Good night, Midwest Cowgirl. Have a good one. Have a good night and a great day tomorrow. Do y'all know how exactly it's messing up your computer? I don't. I'll say what I heard is happening, but if you want to look it up for like better information, what I heard is that it's running an additional like EXE file on your computer. I don't know if it's like sending information, receiving information, if it's changing anything on your computer. It's just there's a file in there that's not supposed to be there, and the reason we know that is because they're changing mods that actually exist. Like, these are real modders that they've had their work up, and then someone has come in like pretending to be these modders and like uploading fake versions of these mods that seem normal, but they have like an additional piece in there that's not supposed to be there. And you know, like, that's not what you're signing up for when you're downloading that mod. So I think that's what makes it really really like concerning. But yeah, it's a couple different mods, so it could be different people doing these things too. So, you know, depending on the mod, depending on when you got it, where you got it, it could be doing something different. So I would just, you know, look into it. If you're worried about a certain mod, you know, maybe try like Google it. Like, I think like the key search for words would probably be like Sims malware mod, and then like maybe if you are concerned about a specific mod, like, you know, pop that in there. I wonder if Twisted Mexi's had any sleep seeing his Mard God. Now is at 1.4. Yeah, I'm in his Discord and I get so many updates. I'm like, he is busy. He's booked and busy. Malware behavior in general can vary, ranging from preventing you from opening software to stealing or deleting data. Yeah, and that's like worst case scenario. Well, there's definitely like worse things that it could do. Can steal a lot of your data, passwords, credit card information, Instagram info, Facebook info, and possibly install crypto miners onto your PC, bog down your CPU, disk space, basically, yeah, lots of bad stuff. Lots of bad stuff, but that's not us saying specifically that's what these mods are doing, but, it's one of the possibilities. I don't know if I've seen anyone say exactly like if like what the bad thing is that it's doing. Let's see, what else can we do today? Test alien environment, is that something you do on this? Yeah, there we go. Okay, yeah, we'll do that. I recommend Wildware Bytes for virus detection. It's free and works super well. Also, Windows Defender is a good paid for program. Yeah, just make sure you're getting like a legitimate one of those too. Downloading anything, just make sure, you know, you're getting a reputable one, because like, yeah, we would hope that the mods themselves are are reputable, that the malware detectors or the virus software that you're using is good. But, you know, you always kind of have to, you know, whenever you're installing anything on your computer, you know, there's a level of risk. Unless you're getting it, like, directly from Microsoft. Like, I don't think they've ever had any issues. All right, what else should we do today? Should we work on the rocket? I mean, we could work on a logic skill. So if we use the microscope, I think that helps with our logic skill. So let's just use the microscope for now. Because we're at level 6 and we need to be at level 10. I think there's a post on Discord that included a list of files within the malware and what they do. Always stay safe, guys. Exactly. Yeah. Again, anytime you download anything on your computer, there's like a certain level of risk that you're taking on. But that doesn't mean you should like avoid things altogether, you know, just like, you know, just go with the level of risk that you're comfortable with. So this person says, hey, Julep, I've heard a lot about Very Berry. I know you don't admit everyone. No, you can't be part of my Very Berry club. The Very Berry club is the club we have with our household. So that way we can get like boosts and bonuses and stuff like that. So no, I'm not just going to let any random person into it. Like I'll probably put like our kids into the club like once they get older too. I think they have to be at least a kid to be in a club. No, can you keep doing this, please? Deadpool Discord is a great resource for mod updates and news, like these mods being compromised. Exactly, yeah, I'm in a bunch of different, like, modding Discords, and they were, like, all, like, red alert with this, like, over the weekend. We leveled up our logic skill, and we have a little bit more time at work, so we can just kind of keep going, help that get up a little bit faster, too. But yeah, this rarely happens. I feel like in the time that I've been modding, I don't really see this happen too much. I remember there was, like, an issue with, like, reshade a while ago. But yeah, just, you know, again, a level of risk anytime you download anything. And this is precisely why I was scared for so long. We got promoted. It looked like usually it's like a bigger box. I wasn't sure. But yeah, we got promoted to Pioneer of New Technologies. We'll make 45 additional simoleons per hour for a grand total of 187 simoleons. And ooh, our bonus is big too. 1,136 simoleons and new clothes. All right, it's our birthday. We should do something. Should we go out to dinner or something? Because I think you can order a cake at a restaurant, right? I haven't done that in a long time. I honestly don't play with restaurants that often. But with this save file, I feel like we've been playing a lot with restaurants. It's just kind of fun. And I also want to give her a makeover. Maybe we'll do that tomorrow for her new young adult thing. Invite in. Yeah, maybe you can come to dinner with us. That could be nice. Are your needs good? If not, I'm just gonna cheat him. Oh no, shoot, the inspector's here. I don't know if we've been keeping up with all of our neighborhood action plans. All right, I'm gonna up all their needs because tonight's a party. And he's already in a bad mood because he's having a midlife crisis, so this is the least I can do. All right, so yeah, let's go out for dinner. I think that'll still count as celebrating because I know sometimes you get a bad mood lit if you don't like celebrate like properly. But I think this should be fine because I think they can bring out a cake at the restaurant. And I think as long as you have a cake, it should be fine. Where should we go? I want it to be like our restaurant. I don't think we've gone anywhere over here yet. Moon Sun's Noodles, maybe. Does it have any information? Doesn't. I wish I could like preview like what the dress code is and stuff. Oh, actually no, we did like this one. Yeah, let's go to this one. I know that one has a formal dress code. That's nice. Okay, they're vegetarian. When I'm ordering for them, remember that they're vegetarian. I'm always so bad at that. I don't think I've messed up recently, but I've almost messed up. I think we messed up once already, and I'm like trying to avoid it again. Honestly, that's a challenge in itself. Uh-huh. All right, request a table, please. Oh no, it's like a blizzard. But it's my birthday. I want to celebrate my birthday. Hello. One table, please. Are we having a suggestive conversation while we're asking for a table?
That's Rishu, with a souk.
You're gonna seat us outside? Wow, what a hater. It's freezing outside. Can we have a different table? Go on. This song is a Jamaican. It's so good. So good. This waiter hates us. We're gonna be freezing our booties off. It's my birthday. It's because you're having a suggestive conversation. They're like, oh yeah, so there is a bring out the cake. Yeah, we gave them the ick, so they sat us outside. Let's just all get the same wine. She's not pregnant anymore, so she can drink our coworker. All right, what's vegetarian here? This is vegetarian. Yeah, maybe that'll be what we get, the glazed heirloom bamboo roll. And then maybe the vodka pasta. Yeah, that's vegetarian. We'll get that for him. And then I don't think our coworker is vegetarian, so maybe she can get the cubed ahi, because that's what I would want. That's what I would honestly want if our sim wasn't vegetarian. All right, let's order. Ours is, and then I just have to remember to bring the cake out at the end. Bomadoo. Yeah, at least like they don't have a moodlet that they're cold. I don't know. Maybe it's like because there's a roof over their head, they don't notice that it's cold. But the poor things, they have like their breath is showing because they're so cold. Alright. Let's see. Let's try to be funny. Hopefully we don't flirt with her in front of our dude because he's very jealous. And we've already got the slap. We already got slapped by him before. So we gotta be careful. We've forgiven him. We've looked past it. Is she flirting with me? You better not. Oh my god, I freaking swear. Because she's in a flirty mood. You better chill out. Did that happen? Did that happen? Is he gonna get mad at me? Is he mad at me? Okay, jealous pangs. Okay, I don't think he actually saw us flirt. I don't think we flirted. Apparently we're running away. What happened? You guys better not be flirting. Stop it. You're gonna get me in trouble. I'm gonna stop talking to you. I'm stopping. Why did we invite her? Why did we invite her? She's gonna get me in trouble. You better stop. I'm not talking to you anymore. You better keep it in your pants, girl. You're the one who got married first, okay? I thought that maybe we would, like, maybe have something going on, but you got married to Don Lothario. Just because you're not happy with Don Lothario, you know, doesn't mean you should ruin my relationship. Okay, everyone shut up and eat. Shut up and eat. I don't want to get slapped again. I know, I'm so stressed now. I wasn't expecting for this to be a stressful situation. It's supposed to be my birthday dinner. Okay, I think we're okay. I don't think anything happened. It's just because she keeps like talking in the flirty way, you know, where they're like, ah, shaboo, da da da. Like, I'm worried that they're flirting. Please don't flirt. Maybe if we just flirt with our fiance in front of her, maybe she'll like get the hint. Yeah, let's blow a kiss. Be like, oh my gosh. Eat, no talk, right? Everyone zip it. Zip it. Yeah, because I think he's just jealous in general. I don't think like he actually saw anything. Because I didn't even see the first time someone else flirted with her. He just showed up and like smacked the crap out of her. And I was like, oh, someone must have flirted with us. I was like, that's not good. Oh, now all of a sudden your phone's interesting now that you see me making kissy faces at our man. That's what I thought. Why did they walk off? What interaction needed them to stand? I don't know. I was nervous. I just canceled it and I didn't look at what it was. Maybe we should just elope right now. Lock it in before anything bad happens. Oh my god. Yeah, I was very nervous. I panic canceled the interaction. I don't know what it was supposed to be. Oh, at least you liked the wine. What kind of wine was it? They all finished it, so I can't check, but she seems like she really liked it. From drinking nectar. Right, should we ask them to bring out cake? Ooh, all different kinds of cakes. Ooh, we can have a tiered cake. Strawberry cake. Ooh, cheesecake. I don't know if you can do a birthday cheesecake, though. Let's just do strawberry cake. I resist. I reset Sims when I want them to stop. If I got desperate, I definitely. Oh, that was immediate. Add birthday candles. Oh my gosh, not the blizzard ruining our birthday. Wait, no, come back. Come back. Sit down. Please. Why are you yelling at us? Chill out. All right, hold on. Let me take some pictures. Okay. Stop talking about honey so I can take some pictures, please. Okay, well, now the waitress is in the way. Oh, this is actually kind of a cute picture. Oh, I was accidentally inside that girl's head. All right, let me. Oh, excuse me. What the heck? Hold on. Close. Go away. What is this? I never seen this pop up before. If I take another picture, will it go away? Okay, it went away. That's so weird. That's never happened before. I think that was not Steam. I think that was, what is it called? EA app. I almost called it Origin again. But it is not called Origin anymore. It sounded like Steam. I think maybe it was me taking a picture. I don't know. Yeah, let me try to get some. Oh my gosh, why do you keep doing that? Oh, because of in-game overlay? I thought I turned that off. Hold on, let me see if I can fix that real quick. If I open up the EA app while I have the game open, let me save real quick. I thought I turned off that shortcut. The EA app always be messing with me. Hopefully I could open it while the game's open and it doesn't F anything up. Tier cheesecake? That would be delicious. All right, where's my setting for that? I think I had to like Google it last time, honestly. In-game overlay. How come I can't turn it off? It's like locked on. I wish I could show you guys what it looks like, but it's like it won't let me toggle it off. Hold on, Ryan's here. Do you see it? Yeah, I don't know if it's because I need to restart the game. I'm just going to take a couple more pictures and I'll deal with it later. Rude, if you ask me. Hey, where are you going? Please. Why do you keep yelling at me? What is the deal? It just says be jealous. Well, stop being jealous. Please. Pretty please. I just hope it's taking the picture okay, even if... The overlay's popping up. Look at him. He looks. Oh no, I thought he was gonna look pissed. Now he looks into it. We're fine. Can you move your hand? I shouldn't have even invited you. Regrets. I have regrets inviting this lady. Okay. Hopefully, at least some of those pictures turned out okay. All right, let's sing happy birthday. Celebrate. Make a wish. Make a wish. Can you sit down? Stop yelling. You haven't even eaten your food. Just sit down and eat your food. just chill out, please. Yay! Block candles. Oh, does he not like his food? Oh, does that have meat in it? I thought I was vegetarian. You're distracting me. I'm trying to pay attention to her aging up. Oh, look at everyone! That was cute. It's like when someone starts having like a birthday, like on the table next to you and everyone gets all excited. Yay, adulthood, fulfilling dreams, planning for retirement, and midlife crisis awaits. The perfect time to start wrapping up those lifelong goals. She's only an adult. She's not like dying or anything dramatic. Ooh. They're like, oh my gosh, you're like really old now. Does this have meat in it? It says vegetarian safe. Maybe he just doesn't like it. You don't have to eat it then. That's fine. Yeah, let's have a kiss for our birthday. Stop yelling at me. I didn't do it. Physical intimacy? Dip kiss, please. Oh, we're going to dip kiss him though, huh? Not the other way around. I like how she had to come all the way out here to age up because of the balcony. Oh, where are we going? We're going all the way around? Oh, there we go. Turn back around. Oh, you're stuck. Mirror, please. Yeah, maybe we'll do a makeover tomorrow if I'm able to stream tomorrow. Oh, lovely. Lovely.
are tripping.
Why are we fighting? Oh my gosh. I thought, didn't I just say earlier in stream, I'm like, I think they're going to be less toxic now. Not actually happening. Cut cake with Keanu. I think that's if you're getting married. Do we just like call to eat? I don't know. I guess we'll just take a serving. We'll just take a piece of cake.
Oh, true.
Yeah, jealous pains. Okay, we're jealous too. I don't know who he flirted with, or I think it's just being out and about. I haven't played with the jealous trait in a while, so I honestly don't know what they're all upset about. Like, I don't know if that actually means that something happens, or if they're just jealous in general. Okay, you're gonna have to stop yelling at me in the restaurant. I can't really defend your actions, just so you know. Where are we going? Why are we doing this? Maybe it's just so cold. She has to like keep walking around. She's like, my toes are gonna fall off. She's just gonna eat on the bench, but she's still in a conversation with them.
Oh, Pimpini.
She's like, I just need some fresh air. You guys are stressing me out. They're stressing me out too. Oh, we just became good friends. That's nice. At least stop. Cancel these interrupts. I'm gonna reset you. Tired of you. Here, pay for our food and shut up. Shut up, please.
Oberoi! Janelle!
You just came to pay. Maybe we should have just done like either pairing, like us with our coworker or us with our fiance, but not all together. That was a, you know, that's not even probably like the most like stressful dinner situation I've ever had in this game. I've had way stressful dinner situations. That's a totally normal place to sit. You know, I just, we needed a breather. Did our coworker leave? Well, we did pay, so I guess she's like, all right, bye. Oh, and this guy's shoveling snow over here. Good job. Good job. Why is her phone on her plate? What is that? What happened here? I don't know if I've ever seen that. I don't know why it's like that. I gotta take a picture. Sorry, the overlay is gonna pop up again. It won't let me turn it off. I think I have to turn off the game before it'll let me stop whatever that is. All right, get out of our conversation. Thank you. Alright. I guess we can just go home then. Shall I Discord DM you a reminder to turn it off? I might turn it off, like, right now. Like, maybe we'll take a quick break to turn it off. That's gonna annoy the crap out of me. Yeah, we do have ads coming in a little bit, so maybe during the ad break I'll, like, restart my game. Yeah, I turned that off, like, a while ago, so I wonder if, like, the EA app, like, updated or something. So, it, like, just turned it back on for me. I don't like being auto-opted into stuff. That's like one of like my technology pet peeves, when they like auto enroll you and stuff and like just like turn on these random settings that you don't want. Every Sim's toxic trait, never being able to stay seated. No, never. yeah, poop. I mean, it has been for a very long time. I think that's a generally accepted fact. Should we try for baby? See if we have a maybe, you know, it'll soothe his jealousy, you know, see if, you know, we get lucky on the birthday, because we are actually wanting a baby. I can't remember the last time I've like woohooed with somebody since the 100 baby challenge, and I'm like, yes, hopefully they're pregnant. Most of the time I'm like, oh my god, I hope they're not pregnant. I feel like I haven't actually hoped for a pregnancy since the 100 baby challenge, which has been like a really long time. Oh, what happened there? Keanu can't stop laughing. That joke Julep just told him was way too good. After being dazzled by that marvelous bit of humor, Keanu thinks about jokes and how great they can be for conversation. In this moment of realization that Keanu likes jokes? Sure. Apparently she decided to open up like, hey, should we try for a baby with like a joke? Legacy challenge must get pregnant, right? That's kind of part of the challenge. Yeah, everything else has been unintended. Yeah, especially during our college playthrough where we had 8 Sims in uni. Oh my. Every single one of those pregnancies was very much unintended. And there were a lot of them. I think I had to turn off like autonomous woohoo, because they were just like, they were making babies like quicker than I could stop them. That cauldron was hilarious. I'm glad you think so. I'm doing 100 baby, and I hope it does that for me, because my favorite things on Sims is having babies. If I burn myself out, then I'll probably go into not so berry. Honestly, I loved 100 baby challenge. I did not get burnt out at all. Yeah, I had so much fun with it. Hopefully you have a lot of fun with it too. But yeah, sometimes it's kind of nice to have like something else that you're doing, so that way, like, if you do feel like you want to switch it up, you could switch it up pretty easily. Yeah, I'm also liking Not So Berry, but I'm not even done with the first gen yet. So, but so far, so good. I like it. All right, I'm just gonna let them do their thing. I think I do have my pregnancy mod and everything in, so should be fine. I think we can check if we're pregnant. All right, I forget which one it is. I think it's this one for the mod. All right, go use the other bathroom. Oh yeah, okay. Let's see if she's pregnant. I don't know, her face looks concerned. I don't know what that face is. That looks like a very concerned face. Not pregnant. All right, all right. You know, that's okay. Sometimes it's just not meant to be. Here, why don't you take a shower? You use the restroom and then go to sleep. We'll try again some other time. I'm actually surprised. Sometimes, like, my Sims, I feel like they're, like, extra fertile. And they get pregnant, like, first time, first try. And I'm like, whoa. Wasn't expecting that. But this time, not too bad. Yeah, he's just still having his midlife crisis. I think everything else is fine. Hi, Sparkles Chaos. I have a challenge and a legacy going at the same time, so I don't burn out. Yeah, sometimes it's nice to have two separate things to, like, switch in between. I feel like it really does help. Thank you for the follow. Yes, welcome in. I hope you're having a good day. Is our laundry full? I guess it is. Here, actually, how about you do some laundry? Pretty please. Yeah, she's like, it's dirty. Do something about that. Which pregnancy mod do you prefer? I ask everyone that question because I'm looking for so many. I can't choose. I have like a mix. I have I think I have Wonderful Whims, and I have Spoiled Food in my pocket. I have Wonderful Whims, and then what's that other one I have? The one by Lupino. I don't even know what it's called right now. It's like called RFP? I don't feel like it's called RFP. ROP? It's by Lupino mod for sure. Let me see. What is it called? Maybe it is called RPO. Thank you. Yeah, by Lupino. Thank you so much for the help. But I like those two together. That's what I, and then the like giving birth one is good too. Who's that one by? Do I not have that one in my game right now? I think I do. Who's it by again? Sorry, I'm just pulling up my mod so I can check who it's by. Yeah, the Lupino one, and then the Panda Sama childbirth mod. That one's a good one too. Anyone know any good Maximash hair creators? I'm in need of some new hairs, but everything on Tumblr is too alpha type. I think on my CC finds, I have a couple of my favorite creators at the top of the list. It's like a mess right now because I'm still organizing it, but there should be on that list, there should be like my favorite creators at the top, and some of them are hair. Relationship/pregnancy overall. Thank you so much, Blix. I forgot the name. Perfect. I know both of those. Thank you for writing them down. Yeah, thank you so much for the patience. Hi, Coupon Nut. How are you doing? It's good to see you. Okay, are we going to bed or not? Were you so disgusted with the dirty clothes that you just decided to not go to bed? All right, and you have work in like 4 hours. Yeah, in 4 hours, so take care of that. Oh, you have to reach logic level 2 and then browse intelligence. I'm not really too focused on you, my dude. So, you know, continue. Do whatever you want to do. Yeah, I'll check the page out. Yeah, no pressure. But not so very, how fun. Yeah, we just tried for a baby. It was unsuccessful, but I don't think she's sad about it. I know sometimes they get sad about it. Wait, it said failed pregnancy scare. Wait, what did it say? Just a pregnancy scare from failed pregnancy test. Thankfully, the pregnancy test came out negative. Julep doesn't want children just now. So she doesn't necessarily want kids, technically. It's a legacy challenge, so you kind of have to have kids, my girl. But yeah, I forget. I think I think with the mod it goes under, which area does it go under? This one does not want kids right now. So I don't think she's like anti-kids. She just is like, I'm still so young. It says this sim is not interested in being pregnant as of now. If it were to happen, they would take it badly. Never mind. I guess she really doesn't want kids. We do have ads coming up in a little bit. I'll give you guys another warning before they run. But I'll probably take another break because what was I going to do? Oh, I was going to restart my game so I could turn off that dumb thing. Fear of being cheated on. Yeah, I think they both have that fear. She has fear of death and fear of being cheated on. I think he has fear of fire. Yeah, because he almost died in a fire. And then fear of dead-end job and then fear of being cheated on. They're both jealous sims. So that I feel like that kind of goes hand in hand. As you were saying, take it badly. I thought you were just going to say they take it back. They're like, nope. No thanks, not for me. Yeah, maybe I should get them some logic stuff so that way they can work on that. Maybe I'll do chess table. Like, you know what I mean. Let's get them a chess table. I feel like instead of that other table that they had. Cute little mint house. I'm glad you think so. I really like it. I like how it turned out a lot. Maybe I should have kept the chair that was there. Did I put that close enough? I didn't. There we go. Okay, so go play some chess. Oh, your builds are so good though. I'm not surprised. Oh, actually, I didn't make this one. This one's by Avalyn Sims. Let me double check how to spell her name. Avalyn Sims on the gallery. Let me see. Sorry, sometimes it takes a while for their names to sort out. Here we go. Avalyn YT. I think you can see it. Yeah, right there. Her builds are really good. I just made it more mint. It was like just a normal like neutral build and I just made it more mint like. But thank you. I do like my build. I just didn't have like the brain power to do a build for this. I was like, I'm just going to consult the experts and just have them make a build. Thank you so much. You made it minty fresh. I did. Thank you so much. Picuna. Oh, Lomish. Yeah, do we have enough? No, almost. We almost have enough to do a logic boost, which they both kind of need. So we'll start a club gathering and then hopefully we get there. Yeah, I get that. Sometimes I don't have the brain power either. I've been like really into like doing casts and making sims lately, and I haven't been too much into building. But a lot of times it flips where like I don't feel like doing casts, but I love doing building. And sometimes I'm like into gameplay. It just really depends. I like go in between all of them. Hi, Simsy loves a lot. How are you doing? It's good to see you. All right, how are you doing? Oh, are you late for work? I'm so sorry. Go to work. Oh, it just turned 7. We're fine. Everything's fine. All right, the ads are starting in a little bit. I'm not going to go anywhere. I'm just going to save my game and restart it so I can turn off that setting. But the rest of you guys are going into ads. Here's some heart jellies if you guys want to gamble. Good, my birthday was yesterday. Happy birthday. Keanu, yeah. So he's a mix of Keanu, John Wick, and Akira Kibo, which is a sim. So he's a mix of all three. I think I missed a lot. Yeah, we're on like part 7, but the series is on my YouTube, on my VOD channel. So if you want to catch up, you could always watch those at like 2x speed too and like skip around. Okay, turning off this freaking in-game overlay. Yeah. Turn that off. Ease up, Pope. What else do I want to turn off while I'm here? I have automatic updates still on, and I think I'll leave them on because the EA app is just so weird. I don't even know how to force downloads anymore. Like, on the Origin app, I knew how. On this one, I have no idea. Like, I just kind of have to keep pressing things until it does that. BRB, too. Have a good BRB. All right, let's reopen the game. Actually, while that's opening, I'm going to go refill my water. I'm just going to roll out of frame. Excuse me. Ah, never mind. Crashing into things. am. Yeah, like our, I feel like we have a lot of stuff in our apartment right now because we did a Costco run last week before the Super Bowl, and we got like so much sparkling water because I've been on like a huge sparkling water kick. But even though we were planning on getting sparkling water, we got even more than we planned to because one of our favorites was on sale. It's called Chi, I think is how I pronounce it. I would say Chi. It's like C-H-I. And it comes in like a peach and a lychee flavor. So good, very tasty. So that's we got two cases of that because it was on sale, and I love things when they're on sale. Very tasty sounding. It's so good, so good. I kept seeing people that having like multiple in their carts like before we even got to that section, and I was like, wow, I keep seeing people with like two cases of it. And then so we went over there, we got one, and Ryan was like, should we get another one? And he's like, because it's on sale. And I'm like, oh yeah, let's get another one. So like I felt like every cart that we saw going past us had like two cases of it. All right, we do have ads for a little bit longer, but I'm gonna go ahead and just keep going because she's just sleeping, so not a big deal. Yeah, now I should be able to take screenshots without everything being ugly. All right, and she had bad food in her pocket. Oh, she has cake in her pocket. Oh, I accidentally put it under the paper towel holder. Oh, got it. Any other food in here? Now we're good. Welcome back from ads. Hello, hello. You guys didn't miss much. I just relaunched my game after turning off that one setting, and she just woke up and used the restroom. So you guys didn't miss anything. We do have to have two more breakthroughs, but it's already 8:30, so I don't think she'll have any other breakthroughs right now. Uh-oh. All right, blown cover. While working an assignment, one of Keanu's agents has had his cover blown. Protocol says to pull the agent from the field immediately, but the agent wants to finish the job. Should Keanu order him to escape or let him finish? I mean, if he wants to finish... F protocol. I feel like that's something Keanu would do. F protocol, let him finish. The information the agent retrieved was so valuable, Keanu's superiors don't care that he broke the rules. Performance gain small. There you go. I know it's literally like, what, like 50-50 if it goes well or not, but I'm gonna take that as a sign that he's just a good spy. I think that's kind of like the closest job besides like criminal that we have to be having John Wick's job. All right, let's just read something. I don't think it matters. Oh, I didn't set up the focus mood before he left. I don't think I can set it up now that he's gone. It's all right. We don't have our breakthroughs anyway, so we can't get a promotion. We just got one, so I'm really not too worried about it.
Bombs are felling us.
Oh, do we have enough? No, we still don't have enough club points to get the logic bonus. Yeah, she just has to have two more breakthroughs, and then she can get the last promotion? Oh, no, two more. So she's level 8 right now. And I believe there's 10 levels in this field. Ooh, we had a breakthrough. I wasn't even trying. All right, let's go. Let's go to work. I'll check on whatever the breakthrough was when we get there. I've only accidentally sent her to work by herself once, and it was Harvest Fest, so I think the game was just confused. It wasn't my fault. All right, so it says Julia Berry had her 15th breakthrough and wrote down an idea for the Spark Drive Serum. Spark Drive Serum. What does it do? Come on, what does it do? Hello? Did I turn off my overlay? There it goes. Drink the serum to make your sim energize. Very nice. Okay, so we only have to have one more breakthrough now for the promotion. All right, what do we want to do today? Make it lunch hour for 3 coworkers using mind control. I don't think I've updated my thing to do that, my sim ray. Is that a upgrade that I can make? I don't know if that's something I can do. upgrade the sim ray with, oh, mind control sleep. Okay. There we go. I didn't see that other one. Upgrade sim ray, mind control sleep. Here we go. Oh, can you change your outfit for me, please? I'll just use MC Command Center. Sometimes I forget that you can do that. And it just does it automatically, so it doesn't mess with their queue. Congratulations on your recent birthday. Thank you. I almost forgot about it. Good thing I did it. Whenever my game lags, I just clear out the notification wall and it gets more smooth again. I've been doing that since 100 baby challenge and it always helps, especially because my 100 baby challenge save file, once we started having like, you know, like lots and lots of kids, my save file was very much struggling. Yeah, her work clothes, her hair never stays mint, so I made this like additional outfit where her hair is mint just to, for consistency's sake, so she's not wearing the most recent outfit. That's okay with me. As long as her hair is mint. I tried like updating the work outfit, but it wasn't like sticking for some reason. Okay, cool, we did that. Okay, mind control is sim to clean. I can do that. Oh, we don't have the sim ray in our pocket. I'm like, hello, where's my mind control? Thank you.
Roshun.
And then make it lunch hour for 3 coworkers using mind control. Is that just sleep? Is that what that means? Just to make them sleep? If they burst into flames, I'm gonna be really disappointed in myself. Georgia Bay. Her evil laugh. Maybe it makes them hungry. Oh, maybe. I assume it means sleep. Let's see if it crosses off if I do sleep.
Oh, Spino, Spino.
Yeah? No?
Ah.
Oh. It didn't cross off yet. Maybe he needs to, like, go lie down? I don't know. Maybe I did it wrong. Alright, there's also attempt alien contact, so we could do that. Which I feel like sounds more important anyway. Hello? Aliens? Can you hear me? We did watch the Marvels recently because we had seen- Hi? Margaret David? Hi! Okay, hold on. Let me make a good first impression. Hold on. I wasn't expecting that. Because I feel like we've done that before and nothing happened. Dang, you got a dumpy. Oh, Charity doesn't like me? Am I like the first alien you've met? Or like, do you already not like, is it my fault you don't like humans? I'm sorry. Hold on, I need to see what her first impression of me was. This alien already doesn't like me. She thinks we're stuck up and we think she's, no wait. No, she thinks we're clingy, we think she's stuck up. Clingy? I mean, you don't gotta read me like that. Like maybe she's just, she's really good at knowing what's up, but. Maybe we are a bit clingy, you know? I'm sorry. Is she gonna be like our new coworker now? What the heck was that? Wait, what was that? I don't know. Now she wants to go use she wants to go observe the sky. Should I just let her? I'm like concerned. I don't know. That seems sus. I don't know what that was all about. Make Sims ravenous using mind control? Okay, what are these options? I don't remember us having these options. I can make someone ravenous? At least that guy's sleeping. Okay, so I made that guy sleep. Where's the rest of my coworkers? Did you guys see the alien by any chance? Ravenous? How do you spell ravenous? Ravenous? Yeah, that's not an option. How do you do that with the mind control ray? Ravenous, thank you. Yeah, I don't know. Mind control? Sleep? Eat? Oh, eat? Maybe? Yeah, that's what it wants me to do. Okay, well, I'm gonna not do this. Xenophilia from interacting with aliens, behaving like the captain of a space journey. I mean, we think it's pretty cool, so... Suffocated by friendship from close-knit lifestyle? Who's that about? She about to summon her whole family, right? What if she's, like, trying to mind control me to, like, open up, like, a bigger rift to, like, let in, like, alien colonizers or something? I think I should be against that, personally. Bro, let's see if this works. Oh, maybe that's what it means by lunch hour? Maybe making them eat? Maybe that's what it meant. Let's see if it crosses off. Oh, there we go. Okay, cool. At least now that technically does both of them, because I had make it lunch hour for 3 coworkers and then make it them ravenous. So I can do both and then it'll double dip, which I love that. Like when that was an option in college where you could take like one class that counts for like multiple like requirements, I would always do that. I love being efficient. Why not? Like, I always try to pick classes that would work for multiple. Heckers, yeah, 2 birds, 1 stone, right? That's why I was able to graduate early. I'm like, I'm not staying here longer than I have to. That would be silly. It costs money to be here. All right, one more coworker. I thought sleep. I don't know why I thought sleep when it said one lunch hour, but having them eat makes way more sense. Like, way more sense. All right, synthesize serum. What did it say? Which one? Simify. Do I have the stuff for Simify? I don't. I need parsley. I keep forgetting that I need that. Oh, I could just water a plant. That's also one of them. A lot of these look messed up. Does no one else take care of the plants? Is it just me? Upgrade satellite dish. Oh, the alien probably wants us to upgrade the satellite dish. Where is it? Did the alien steal my satellite dish? Oh, there it is. I don't even see the alien anymore. I don't even know where she was. Let me see. To upgrade the satellite dish. Oh, I need to put it on the... Is it drag it? Invention constructor, then click invention constructor. Oh, is it not mine? Is that why I can't take it? Can I steal it? How come I can't? Do I need to make another one, maybe? Because technically that one's not mine. Yeah, I don't think I can cheat it. I think I'm just gonna have to make it. Yeah, that would waste some time, but I should probably just try to make it. A new satellite dish that's actually mine so I can upgrade it. No one waters the plants unless you need to. I'm like, come on. They're dying, poor things. Worst part about meeting people at bars is you meet people that go to bars. As someone who went to bars recently, I feel that. I feel like I can probably on one hand count the amount of times that I've went to bars. No, maybe 2 hands, which is not a lot. But yeah, we did go to the bar, when was that, Saturday? But thankfully I had kind of already met all those people. So it wasn't bad at all. I had a good time. People were really nice. But again, I feel like, yeah, like my chances of, like, you know, doing something embarrassing, let's say, are like 10%. And if I have 10 conversations, that means at least one embarrassing thing is gonna happen. So, you know, it's just, you know, the odds weren't in my favor. All right, are you still on the lot? You are. Okay, you're just walking around. If you had showed up yesterday, I would have invited you to my birthday party. That's not how probability works. Oh my god, you're just intent on making me sound dumb today. I don't know. Math is not my strong suit. That's why I stopped being an engineering major. You do the math for me then. This is why I always ask you to do the math for me. I don't know what I'm talking about. I didn't say anything else. You do the math for me then. I don't even know what to ask for. This is why I always ask you. I'm like, okay, this is on sale. What does that mean? Like, how much on sale is it? Yeah, technically math was like the only class I ever failed in college. I got like a D in calculus, so I had to retake it. Like, it counted as a pass, but like, I technically, no, I think because I switched majors, I had to take like a different kind of math. Was it stats that I had to take instead? Yeah, I don't think I had to retake calculus because I don't think my new major needed it, but I think it technically counted as a pass. Maybe I should have made it. Oh, I couldn't do pass, no pass. Yeah, at my school, if you were an engineering major, they wouldn't let you take a class pass or pass, no pass. But when I switched majors, I was allowed to take a class pass, no pass. but the teachers would get mad. Like, how are you? I feel like that's not fair that they know if you're taking the class pass, no pass. Because one of my teachers was mad when he found out that I was doing that. I'm like, well, I think he thought it meant that I didn't want to try in the class, which is not a lie. I kind of didn't really want to try. But yeah, he was a little offended that I did that. All right, was there anything new I can do like this? Do with this? Oh, profanity abductions. Are any of these new? Okay, what are the differences? Because this one's not upgraded. Contact aliens, prevent abductions. Prevent abductions, detect local aliens. Oh, detect local aliens. I saw the alien. I know where she is. Where'd she go? Oh, apparently she left. Never mind. She's not here. all right, we don't have to technically do anything else today. I'm going to see if we can get another Eureka. I think we can do another one by just using the microscope. I think that's how we did it last time. So let's try just doing that. See if we can get another Eureka just by using the microscope. At least it'll help with our logic skill. Yeah, we've been finishing our tasks pretty early at work, which is good. And we did meet an alien today. Maybe we will... Oh, what happened to you? She's all dirty. She got beat up by the alien. Where are all these new people? Did something happen to my coworkers? Oh, we had another one. We had another breakthrough. What's it say? Her 16th breakthrough wrote down an idea for ox strength serum? Ox strength serum. Drink the serum to increase your Sim's fitness. Oh, very nice. At first, I thought you turned your coworker to an alien. If I had that power, that'd be really interesting. I mean, I did change that one lady's skin color temporarily. And I know that it's supposed to be a glitch. In my head, it's canon that I was just really good at being a scientist. Or not. Whichever way you think about it. Apparently, we're not a good scientist because this microscope doesn't like us. Maybe if it was smaller, it'd be easier to use. Just an idea. Reginu? Lamida. All right, so even if we don't get a promotion today, we're pretty much set to have a promotion soon because we hit all the things that we need to do. And did I get my logic skill up anymore? Yeah, we're like halfway through the next level, so we just need to get to level 10. We're almost caught up to mischief. Our mischief is at level 8. Yeah, no promotion. That's okay. We made a good amount of money. If we get pregnant by an alien first, I'm gonna be disappointed in us. But I don't think we can. I forget. Someone came in and told me that it's hard to do to get pregnant by an alien. It's our husband, Tomer. Not our husband, our fiance. I don't even want to invite our coworker in because I'm worried she's going to flirt with us in front of him. I'm like so scared. All right, let's gossip about the alien. I just like to normal gossip, but I'm going to pretend like it's gossip about the alien. But you did an 100 baby challenge. Did I have alien babies? I must have. I had alien babies. I must have, right? At least one. I think doing a pregnancy through abduction is different than doing a pregnancy through like normal woohoo. I think there's a difference. Only male Sims can get pregnant by abductions unless MCC allows you to choose. I think I'll leave it because I don't know if I do want to get pregnant by aliens. I think I'd rather get pregnant by our own fiance first, you know? All right, let me pull out dinner so that way we can eat together because I think that'd be cute. Let me just get this leftover turkey out, fake turkey. Do you want to go out on a date? No, I don't want... You're married. Is she not married anymore? Is our coworker not married anymore? She is, my girl. And you have 3 kids. I just don't think I'm in this time of my life where I want to date someone with kids. It's just my preference. Some tofurkey. Oh, she growled at him. He doesn't even want to sit with us. He's like, girl, you're too much. Keanu would be preferable, right? I wish I could eat turkey legs at Disney. Oh, that sounds so good. This must be chaos. I love it, though. I love that they're trying to make it messy. we're trying to be on a redemption arc, and the game is like, no, how about you go out with your coworker? Does she think that yesterday was a date? We invited her out to our birthday dinner, and she was so flirty the whole time. Maybe she, like, really misread. She let herself into our house through the back door. All right, bye. Maybe she thought it was a date, but our fiance was there. I don't know. But she showed up so flirty. So maybe I just really misread that situation. Wait, don't clean it up. Why aren't you eating it? There we go. Like, your hunger is not going up, my girl. Like, you already finished his food. You've just been making goo-goo eyes at him. He just threw the plate on the table. He's like, clean that up, woman. Oh, no, he was in the middle of making a joke. He got distracted. She doesn't understand boundaries. I really do think that that's probably a problem. I kept, like, checking his, like, moodlets to make sure he didn't think, like, anything happened. But yeah, I didn't see anything, like pop up. Like, oh my god, she cheated on me. Should we try for a baby again? We're both in a very flirty mood. Go ahead. You guys go ahead. And then use the restroom after for your pregnancy test. Balafoy polycamus. All right, have fun, you two. Just in your work outfit. Oh, are you taking the plate with you? She's like, I'm gonna bring this as a snack for when we woohoo. Oh no, she's done. Oh, she just threw it on the ground. She's like, hurry, let's go. Can't even put your plate away first. Baba. Oh. Did I not put it for woohoo? They're just flirting with each other. I mean, continue. This is probably the most healthy I've seen you guys interact in a while. All right, let me just make the suggestion again. You know, they look like we got a new sentiment. Let me see, where was it? Adoring, that's cute. Deeply in love. They almost broke up so many times. Woo, snacks. You know, sometimes you need some refreshments. All right, good luck, guys. Have fun. Let me see if our coworker's still around. Nah, I think she left. That was a little creepy. She just, like, walked in through the back door. Do I not have my doors locked? Lock for everyone but household members. Where's the other door? Lock for everyone but household members. Can't trust people. They're creepy. Do we still have a crush on her? Maybe I should take off the crush. Yeah, I think. Can I remove it? Yeah, remove it. Yeah, there we go. Now we don't have a crush on her anymore. It's making things complicated. It was fun while it lasted, but now she's asking us out on dates. We gotta draw the line somewhere. Alright, pregnancy test. Pregnante? You guys gonna go again? No, they just gotta have a debrief after. She's like, alright, we're gonna need some more pregnancy tests if we keep doing this. At least you don't have to buy them. Like stock up on them. They just appear. Oh, can't see her. You're supposed to lay it down flat after. Ooh. Uh-oh. Ooh. Is that a good face or a bad face? Oh my gosh, she's so shocked. Look at her face. Oh my god. Alright, hold on. That's, like, perfect. Poor thing. I don't know if it's good or bad, because she doesn't technically want kids, so she might be a little miserable if she's actually pregnant. My mansion had triplets, gave birth the next day. My male sim gave birth to an alien baby. He even got pregnant with a second one, sent home alien planet, not doing it again. Oh my gosh, you had, like, so many kids all of a sudden. That is wild. All right, let's see if that means it's positive. Yay, she's pregnant! Oh, she's not very happy about it. It's okay. It's okay. Can you wake up, my dude? We have some news. We have some news. I know, I'm excited. I don't think she's excited, but I'm excited. let me see. Where is it? Pregnancy and family? There's, like, a way. Announce unwanted pregnancy. Oh gosh. I guess that's the only option. I don't think I can force her to be, like, happy about it. I think he can talk to her and it'll kind of help, but yeah, it's I don't think there's a way for me to like I think I could cheat it if I want to, but I don't think I could. I don't think I want to. We'll see how it kind of plays out.
We'll be.
She's supposed to take it back. Or, like, what's the return policy on this? But I think he'll be happy. Oh, no, her crying. It's okay, girly. He's very tense. Pregnancy and uncertainty from partner's pregnancy. Keanu's open to the idea of having children, so he's fine with the news of his partner's pregnancy. It's even a little exciting, but his partner is distraught and freaking out. They don't want this baby. Keanu's not sure what to say or do. Poor guy. He's all like, I don't know what to do. But yeah, not exactly in agreement from announcing pregnancy. Julep's partner took the news of the pregnancy more positively than Julep herself. They're not unreasonably happy, but they still don't seem to really understand how Julep feels about this. Thank you for the follow. Should have wrapped his willy. He wants kids. She's the one who didn't, but like I was the one who kind of forced her hand. Cause unfortunately, this is a legacy challenge, so you have to have kids. It's okay. We excited for the baby. Although I'm excited. He's trying to tell a sexy joke. My dude, here. Can we like comfort her about it? Pregnancy and life. So I'll try to reassure about pregnancy. There you go. Oh no, are you guys about to go again? I don't think you guys can make twins that way, so continue. But maybe we should talk this out first. Her hormones are already going wild. Dang, look how mad she is. Her face is all twisted up. It's okay, baby girl. Oh, nope, she didn't like that. Should we try again? I'm sorry. Share pregnancy worries. Maybe she should share pregnancy worries with him. Hey, don't yell. What is the yelling? I don't like the yelling. Take it down a notch. Let me see. Hopeless future with baby. Oh no. Share worries. Let's start there. Just found out she's pregnant. Already showing. This is interesting. I think there is an option in the mod to make it so that way it's like a little bit delayed. But I kind of like it that it pops up right away because they're only pregnant for a little bit. So I kind of like that it pops up right away. Not mind control, girl. You can't fix everything with mind control. Offer to go to counseling. Wait, hold on. Don't go to sleep. I want to talk about this. Stop going to sleep. We'll go to sleep in a little bit. This is kind of something we gotta deal with. But if we offer counseling right now, does that mean they'll go right now? I don't necessarily want them to go right now. I just kind of wanted to put the idea like on the table, you know? Oh, she's already nauseous too. Poor thing. This is so exciting though. We're gonna have Jen 2 on the way. Oh, they're gonna go right now? Okay, we're going to midnight counseling. It's an emergency. I kind of figured it would happen right away, but I wasn't really thinking it through. I just want her to be happy about it already. Yeah, since baby stuff moves pretty fast, it really does. Dang, it was $90 each. Okay, we're going to bed then. Oh, not nap, sleep. Sorry. I think you already have it in your queue, but I'll put it in there again. Or was that option read to baby? Aw, read to baby sounds cute, but she don't want this baby. unwanted child on the way from Woohoo. Julep did not expect to have a child and is really not sure she wants it at all, but it's happening. What should she do? Poor thing. Morning sickness. Hold on, wait, I'm reading. Let me see, anything else? Not really helpful. This session didn't help Julep feel understood or feel better about the situation. Okay, well, midnight therapy didn't help. He feels confident about it though. Helpful enough. It was good to discuss feelings about this with a professional. He's just handling this much better. Much better than she is. But you know, we have a couple days to figure it out, right? I forget how long pregnancies are. I want to say they're about 3 days. 3 days long. So I don't think we'll see the birth in this stream, but maybe oh, I won't be streaming Wednesday because that's Valentine's Day. Maybe not till next week. We'll see. I'm not sure if I'm going to stream tomorrow because I have an appointment. And our apartment maintenance is supposed to come tomorrow. So it's like I don't want to be like in the middle of a stream when they show up. But if they show up in the morning, I'll be able to stream. But it just really depends. So tomorrow's stream is up in the air. It also depends on how I feel after my appointment. And then Wednesday, yeah, I probably won't stream because it's Valentine's Day and we have a date. He's also not the one pregnant either, right? Like, your feelings, honestly, on this aren't as important. Her feelings about this are a little bit more important. But at least he's somewhat happy about it. Because when we were doing our college challenge, we had another Keanu Sim involved. And he was not happy about the kids. And he had a lot of them. So I feel like he didn't really have a... He probably should have stopped banging everybody if he didn't want that many kids. All right, you're supposed to be at work, like, right now, but... Oh, never mind, you're not going to use the restroom. Oh, you did a little bit. Probably didn't flush. Nasty. All right, let's take a shower. Let's take a bubble bath, actually. Maybe it'll help you out. Poor thing. Yeah, she already has everything that she needs to get the promotion. We just kind of need to make sure she's in a good mood, which might be hard if she's really stressed out about pregnancy and midnight counseling sessions. Yeah, let's see if this bath helps. I think I might run the ads a little bit early, just use the restroom, because might as well. I should probably do it before she goes to work, actually, because I get really distracted while she's at work. All right, I'm going to run some ads and go run to the restroom, just get the ads out of the way for this hour. And I'll see you guys in a little bit. Here's some heart jellies if you guys want to gamble. And yeah, I'll be back in 3 minutes after the ads are done. Bye! Hello, welcome back. The attitude emote was for my loss, not for the ads. But welcome back. Thank you. It's good to see you guys. hopefully that's our last. Whose spirit is? I don't know you. Hopefully that's our last ad for the stream. We'll see though. All right, definitely get some food after you're done. We've been having acai bowls, so hopefully that's okay. Ooh, we have enough for a logic bonus. Okay, I'm gonna start a club gathering, even though he's at work. I don't think it matters. And then I'm gonna get a bonus for logic. Yeah, logic boost. Nice. Haven't had acai bowls in real life in a hot minute. Maybe when it gets hotter. Maybe. I really want to, but like, yeah, my teeth have just been so sensitive lately. I usually get something else when we go there. But I mean, that's really fine too, because I love like everything else they have too. So I'd be perfectly happy getting normal food from there. I mean, acai bowls are normal food. Welcome in, Universalis. I hope you're having a good day. No, let me put it in the bin. The bin. Thank you. Not me accidentally putting it in the wall. All right, is there anything that I can do to help her be okay with the pregnancy? Thoughts on being pregnant? Okay with being pregnant? Not okay with being pregnant. So I can change it here. I think I'm okay with her not being okay with it for like a little while, but if it starts to get like really messy, maybe I'll change it. And send customized letters. What? But yeah, maybe going to some birthing classes or stuff like that would help too. You refuse to make peace with pregnancy. This means Julep will not be able to change her mind regarding pregnancy. No, I want to see if we can like turn it around. I've seen other people really, really try to turn around their feelings, but sometimes it's a little hard to do. Yeah, make ready to accept pregnancy. So if I really want to, like if I want it to work with the story, I can make it so that way it's a little bit easier for her to be a little bit more accepting. But right now it's okay if she's not 100% accepting. Okay, so threat report. Keanu's got a big report on a new emerging threat due tomorrow at work, but he's swamped. He can either secretly ask for help from another researcher or work all night to get it done. What should he do? Let's ask for help. Let's see. Another researcher does a stellar job and Keanu promises to cover for him when he's in a pinch. Keanu's bosses are pleased. Medium performance gain. Nice. It changed over time. Learning to accept to the baby. Yeah, we tried going to counseling and that didn't quite help. But I think if we keep having more conversations about it, it won't be too bad. But she wasn't happy with the last conversation they had about it. I think she's a little resentful. But yeah, especially now that she's an adult and she's pregnant, I definitely want to do like a makeover for her tomorrow if we're able to stream tomorrow. Again, I'm hoping that maintenance shows up in the morning so that way I'm able to stream in the afternoon, because yeah, I just honestly think it would be a little bit awkward have to like stop stream because maintenance shows up. Like I would probably just have to end stream. I'd be like, sorry guys, you're all done. And I feel like the stress, like I would just be like so frazzled. All right, let's practice a little bit of chess. Yeah, I wish they could schedule or give more accurate window. Yeah, like I'm hoping that they would. I can't remember like if we're like one of the first places that they hit or one of the last. So I guess we'll just have to play it by ear. And like, I don't even know, like, what if they come during my appointment? Like, can I just be like, hey, did you guys show up already? Because I'm gonna be gone for like a little bit, and if they come while I'm gone, that'd be nice. Actually, I'd kind of prefer to be here, but I'm not too like worried about it. But the thing is, I want to know. I want to know if they've been here at one of our, like, not our last apartment, but our last apartment. They would like leave a note, like anytime maintenance would come over, even if it was for like a scheduled thing, they would leave like a little like sticky note, and they'd be like, hey, yeah, we were here, this is what we did, this is the time we came, blah blah blah. The last two places we've been to, they don't do that. I don't know, I don't even think it shows up like on like the little portal that they give us, like if they came or not. Maybe I should check. But like I like knowing, like I like when they come and they tell you that they've come, and like it's just nice. Yeah, that's the problem with Windows. Any job they do before can cause a delay. Exactly. Yeah, it's not very convenient. But right now we're talking about it and we're like, yeah, at this point, like honestly, it's nice to rent, because then yeah, if things go wrong, I don't gotta do anything about it. I'm like, I don't know if I want to be a keeper of a house, like take care of a house and have all that responsibility right now. I'm kind of cool, like, you know, having people that do that for me. So I guess, you know, with there's like positives and negatives to it. All right, what can we do today? View a piece of art. Is there even art in here anywhere? Hello, art? Is this art? Can I view? There we go, art. Does that count as a piece of art? I guess we'll see. Yeah, see, they're watering the plants. Yeah, stop being lazy. I've been the only one watering the plants. Well, she's thinking about diapers still. I guess we can ask our friend about children, right? I feel like that's something you can do. Pregnancy and lifestyle. Express feelings about pregnancy. Ask for craved food item. Yeah, express feelings about pregnancy. Yeah, I don't think that counts as a piece of art. Maybe I need to find another one. I don't know if any of these offices have art in them. Does this count as art? It's a poster. You can critique it, so I want to hope that it counts. Aw, they're hugging. I know how to sit, get her chair. She's like, you should sit, since you're pregnant. Hopefully we don't have triplets like her. Hopefully the tripletness didn't rub off on us. Thank you for the follows. Yeah, maybe talking about it with like another girl will like help, you know? All right, we should probably get to work. Thanks for the talk. Does that help? Craving rich food. Yeah, unwanted child on the way. Julep did not expect to have a child and is really not sure she wants it at all, but it's happening. What should she do? Hopefully she's okay with it soon. All right, let's see if this counts for the work that we need to do. Order a coworker to invent. I don't know if I've upgraded it for invent. Oh yeah, I do. Order to invent. Oh no, you just do that. You don't have to use the okay, I give up on this viewing art thing. We're not using mind control to order her, we're just asking her to. Mix ox strength serum. I didn't even see what the recipe was for it. I might not have the stuff. Oh, I do have it. Nice. Hi, Sammy Yam. How are you doing today? Good evening to you, too. I hope you're having a good one. Hopefully you're having a nice, relaxing night. I'm not sure I haven't this song in a while. Then I might not add this to, like, my girly pop playlist that I've been making. There we go. Laying down after roller skating. Oh my gosh, how fun! I kind of want to go roller skating after watching the halftime show yesterday. I used to love going roller skating. I think that the rink in our old town is closed, but I don't know. I haven't looked into if there's a rink around here. I guess technically you don't need a rink, but I don't know. I'm kind of accident prone, so sometimes it's nice to do it at a rink. Usher was amazing. I didn't know he skated. I think there's a movie that he skates in. I haven't seen it. Call me a fake stan. I haven't seen it. Or at least he's involved in this skating movie. I'm not sure. So apparently I need to watch this movie. But yeah, he was amazing. I thought he did a really, really good job, honestly. I was really happy with the performance. I mean, his music was my era of music. Like, my mom's, like, theme song for the longest time was Yeah. And we would listen to the CD, like, before school, after school. It was like, that's, like, my era of, like, music right there. Like, that's what I grew up on. One of the better halftime shows. I agree. It's definitely up there, like, with my favorite ones. Like, a lot of other halftime shows had, like, really good moments. But I feel like I really liked, like, this performance, like, overall. Yeah, me too. I was singing. Oh, I was so into it. I loved it. I, like, knew, like, every song he played. And I feel like that's kind of rare. Like, Okay, I don't think we did that properly, so I'm probably gonna have to clone it again. I'm a good scientist. Stop making me look dumb. Yeah, I was singing like all the songs. Like, even when he started singing Confession, because I had played it earlier that day, and I was all like, this is my confession. So that's like one song that I actually know like a lot of the words to it. So when he only did like a small portion of it, but I was into it. I was like, I was glad that he did it at all. All right, where's my... I did make a new... There we go. What does it want to do? Hive mind. Neighborhood hive mind. Let's do Happy Town. Don't know what it does, but let's do it. Same. Love 90s Usher. Yeah, I was more into like his 2000 stuff. Like 2005, I want to say, is when I started listening to him. Like a lot. All right, what's the next thing we need to do? Clone a serum. Let's do it. I did just make the ox serum. Where's that one? Yeah, let's clone this one. I remember singing Confession when I was a child. I had no clue what he was talking about then. All the songs I used to sing when I was younger, I'm like, wow, little me had no idea that I was singing about a dude who was cheating on his girl, and then his side chick got pregnant, and he's over here trying to beg his girl to stay with him. I'm all like, that's low, man. That's low. There's a lot of songs about cheating from my youth that I had no idea. I had no idea. All right, make Sims ravenous using mind control. Okay, I think we decided that one's like the eat one, right? Yep, right. Like, I didn't even like the Shaggy one. That one I knew. I feel like that one was a little bit more obvious to me growing up that it was about cheating. Like, that one almost made me like uncomfortable. I was like, oh my gosh, what a nasty song. Like, I was such a little like hater growing up. So, I like it now though. I like it for what it is. What's another one? There's like a boy band song, right? You've played it for me recently, right, Ryan? Where they're like, I'm like nearby or something like that. Like, don't wait up for me. You guys have a good night. It was a wonderful discovering. You can't wait to see more. Have a good week. Unless I see you before, then have a good one, Buckeye. Thank you for joining us. I hope you have a good rest of your night and a great day tomorrow. I wasn't allowed to listen to that song. My mom would change the channel, right? Like, it felt like it was like dirty to listen to that song, right? That's how I felt, at least. I was like, I feel like I'm doing something wrong by listening to this song. Not to mention that years later, Shaggy did confirm that it was him. I think even as a child, I could use my powers of deduction to know that it was him. Backstreet Boys, The Call. Yes, that one, like, I don't think I would have, I didn't know that that one was about cheating. Let me see. Remember Pony by Genuine? Is that one about cheating too? I honestly haven't listened to it. Like the lyrics in like a while. Iconic. It is super iconic. That one's a good one.
Oh, Spino.
All right, one more thing. Attempt alien contact. All right, it went swimmingly last time, so let's do it again. Maybe maybe we can talk to the alien about our pregnancy troubles. It's about riding ponies, but not. I think I see that. I understand. Yeah, I don't think I've looked at the lyrics like written out to see what like they mean. There's also Same Girl. That one's a really good one. It's kind of like a different take on like the cheating trope. But if you watch the music video, it's not as it seems. All right, an alien didn't come through that time. We're a little sad about it. That's okay. Let's go ahead and use the microscope to help our logic skill. All right, it looks a little disturbing in triple speed, so we'll just do double speed. At least we're feeling pretty good about work. We're distracting ourselves from with work. Cry me a river, cry me a river. Yeah, I wasn't really into boy bands growing up. I kind of missed that era. Like, I feel like I missed out. But my husband has been really good about showing me different boy band stuff. Because, yeah, I feel like I missed out. Can we not use this anymore? Oh, I'm too tense. I'm too tense to work. Great. All right, I guess we're going to go make a snack then. We're almost done with work anyway. I walked away. Did you say you don't remember Pony? No, I remember Pony. I just don't know if it was, like, about cheating or not. I think that's where my brain went. I was an NSYNC Backstreet Boys fan, but that was it. Yeah, I don't know. Like, I knew of them, but I just wasn't listening to, like, pop music at that time. My family was really into country music at the time. I feel like I talk about this, like, at least once a stream. Because, yeah, it makes sense for the reason why I feel like I missed out on, like, all of these pop references and, like, certain things that other people experience. I just, yeah, I wasn't, I didn't, I didn't, I didn't have that experience of listening to like boy bands like everyone else did. Even now, I'm like, even with like K-pop and stuff like that, I'm more into girl groups than boy groups. I feel like though, if I had like the background of being really into like boy bands earlier in my life, maybe I would be like more interested in boy K-pop. But like, yeah, I'm just more into girl K-pop. NSYNC and Backstreet Boys have definitely led the way for many other boy bands. I agree. Yeah, I mean, like they're iconic enough that like. Even me, who, like, didn't listen to their music, knew about them. Like, and I wasn't a huge One Direction fan either, yeah. Like, maybe if I was more into boy bands growing up, it would have been, like, a little bit different for me. Like, I definitely liked their music. I would listen to it here and there, but, yeah, I wasn't, like, a boy band, like, fan, you know? Oh, she's very sad. What are you very sad about? Not ready for this. Sometimes the torturous nature of being pregnant at a time when you don't want a child hits you like a train. Poor thing. Got some One Direction in the summer. Turned pretty. Yes, that was the perfect time for that song. I feel like boy bands and girl groups aren't around anymore because it's kind of known that they'll eventually break up and go solo. I just feel like, yeah, like they don't really... I feel like... they aren't making these kinds of groups anymore. Like, and the ones that have happened, yeah, they like break up or they go solo. But they're definitely alive and well in Korea. Like, it's really good over there. My grandma got me some Backstreet Boys merch once. I never once listened to their music. Yeah, I feel like it was kind of like they assumed. Like, if you were a girl or like a kid around that era, they're like, you like boy bands, right? Like, I feel like that's like a go-to gift, right? That they would give people. Did we reach level? Yeah, we upped our logic skill. Nice. Treatment of the Stars. Yeah, I think so. Yeah, it's still, like, the treatment of, like, artists in Korea is definitely not great. If you need some, need Rex on some of their songs, I got you. Yeah, Ryan's put some bops on our playlist. But yeah, that new, like, La Seraphim song is so good. I really, really like it. And there's like a cute little animation that goes with it, like a little animated, what's it called? A new animated music video. There we go. Probably heard some of this stuff in passing, but never on purpose. I mean, like, yeah, sometimes like I feel like, yeah, things do kind of pop up. All right, we got a new quirk, emotion bomb. Julep is finding it difficult to process her negative emotions in a healthy manner. Feelings of anger, sadness quickly become overwhelming and always result in an overdramatic emotional response. Oh, it's because she's a rising star. I didn't even want to turn on Fame, but like the restaurants were broken if you didn't turn on Fame. So yeah, we got some quirks. I don't want any of these. I don't want to be noticeable. I mean, I could always quit the spotlight, but we'll stick with it for now. Maybe it'll add a little bit of flavor. I need to see. I just got back into K-pop. Yeah, I definitely come back and forth. Like, I feel like my main era of K-pop was when, like, I was in college, which was kind of a long time ago now. And I've kind of dropped off since then, but I always am, like, kind of, like, aware of it.
Whitney.
The call is stuck in my head now. Oh, gosh, how's that one go? I don't know if I know that one. I'm sure I do, but like the song isn't like popping up in my head. Sometimes I don't know songs by their name. Like sometimes I'll remember the chorus or something like that, which sometimes includes the name of the song, but not always, right? All right, is there anything we can do to help you with your pregnancy thing right now? You're feeling insecure, you're languishing skills from being an overachiever. You literally just upped one of your skills, my girl. Hi Veronica, how are you? Sharing some good vibes for your week. All the love. Thank you. All the love for you too. Thank you. Thank you. All right, let's see. Go to an early parenthood class. Can we go together? Go get Crave food. Let's go do that. Maybe that'll help. We just go by ourselves. Yeah, go ahead, girl. Have some alone time. Screw this man. What are you dazed about? Mental fog from starting burnout again? My dude, get over it. Found the YouTube video. I'll listen tomorrow when I'm not sleepy. Yeah, maybe it'll hype you up too much. God, watch out. Wait, you didn't clean the lint tray, did you? Okay, you did. Yeah, do some laundry. Help out your fiance here. Oh yeah, clean the toilet. Did she throw up? Maybe that's why. Still lurky and making my Sims. Anyone got any good name ideas for my Natto Berry Bin Sim? Oh, we had some really good ideas when we did ours. I can't remember all of them. trying to remember. I know we had a vote and we settled on Julep, but I can't remember what the backup names were. There's a man now. I miss him. Yeah, he's our fiance and our baby daddy because we're pregnant, aren't we? Olivia would like to come over and hang out. Is that okay? I don't know you. Do I know you? I don't think I know you. Sage, yeah. Peppa. Peppa's a cute one. Yeah, Sage, I feel like, is really cute. Like, any mint greenish names, I feel like, are good ones. Let's see. Make peace with pregnancy. Julep is not ready for this. She needs to engage in more activities and conversations that might help her accept her situation better. Let's see. Should we go to a birth class? Or maybe he can say something that'll help her. Let's see. Try to reassure about pregnancy. I don't know. She might punch you in the face, honestly, and I wouldn't really. We can offer. Okay, we can offer to go to an early parenthood class. Maybe that'll make it so that way they go together. Because if I think if I just selected it on her, it would only just be one of us. Colgate. Okay, we got two Colgates. Is that like a? Or you're laughing at Colgate? I mean, Colgate is like, yeah, it's Minty. You could call her like, I don't know. I'm bad at nicknames. Someone else come up with a good nickname. What's another toothpaste brand? Some of them have really funny names. Or like, isn't Tommy? No, I'm trying to think. Tom's? I'm trying to think. There's like a toothbrush, a toothpaste name that like works. Oh, are you stinky? What happened? Oh, Vinba. Okay, it looked like he was glowing green for a second. Okay, what happened? Why? What happened? You're flirty. What happened? Why are you crying? Oh, it's because she has the emotion bomb thing now. Okay, maybe it's not the time for sit-ups. Did we have the discussion that we wanted to have? Did we have the discussion about going to the early parenthood class? Come on, maybe enough sit-ups. Cole is a cute nickname. That is a cute nickname. Tom, there we go. Yeah, Tom is a fresh. Fresh is a good one. So fresh. Or are you just saying that the name is fresh, maybe? Yeah. I'm trying to think. Like, I feel like there were a couple others that we considered, but I can't remember. Okay, there we go. Now they're going to a class. All right, he's focused, learning important stuff. Uh-huh. Oh. Where'd it go? I wanted to read it. No, I wanted to read it. It went away. It, like, sped up time because they were off lot. Is she feeling better? No? No, still not feeling great about it. I wish there was kind of, like, a bar that you could see that they're, like, into it or not. Minty Fresh, you have a nickname Fresh. Let me see. Sensodyne, great toothpaste. I've never tried it, but I feel like I should now that I got sensitive teeth. It's like kind of like the sensitive one. That would be good though, because I feel like Mint Gen is so sensitive. So Sensodyne would actually be a good name. I think I'm going to go with the same first letter as the color, so maybe Mina, Minnie. Oh, I see. I'm stuck on the surname, though. Naming my Sims is always hard. I just did the last name Barry. I feel like a lot of people do that for Not So Barry Challenge, so if that helps take that decision off your plate, I feel like that's an easy one. Yeah, I always suck at naming Sims. I always have people in chat help me. All right, anything we can do right now? Let's see, is there anything we could say to him about being worried about it? Worry about putting on baby weight, share worries about pregnancy. All right, yeah, offer to go to early parenthood class. We already did that one. Yeah, let's share worries. Maybe that'll help. Good night, new pseudonym. Have a good rest of your night. A great day tomorrow. Just good luck with your burying. I'm trying. These kids are fighting me. Aww.
Mibs?
Ooga lump. All right, well, her feeling tense is almost gone, so I'm kind of curious to see, like, what pops up. Oh, second trimester in 14 minutes. Dang, she's about to be in her second trimester. Oh, my gosh. Maybe she'll be happier about it in the second trimester. I don't know. Does the second trimester go smoother, usually? I hope so. Oh, here we go. Excellent class from parenthood class. Julep retained a lot of information from that early parenthood class. It makes the prospects of having a baby in her care seem less daunting. Oh, that's good. Okay, so the class did help. Oh, he feels flirty from the class. All right, class. The class was fast and Keanu didn't retain as much information as he hoped, but it was still helpful. Maybe because you were distracted by your hormones, my dude? That's kind of what I'm seeing. All right, go take care of your needs, please. Please and thanks. Barry is such a good name. A good idea for a same name. I didn't think about that. Yeah, I feel like that one's the easy one. If you're bad at naming things like me, it's an easy one. I'm going to name her Mini Barry. Oh, that sounds so cute. Is Mint the one that's supposed to be the bad parent, or is that Red? Let me see. I think I have the rules. But you're right. I think there's one where, like, they're supposed to have, like, a strained relationship with their kid. I don't think it is Mint. I'm just trying to, like, scroll through real quick. It says for Rose, you have absolutely no parental instincts whatsoever, but you still love your child with all your heart. Only have one child. So maybe that's the one? Yeah, that one's under Rose, so maybe that's the one where you're not so good of a parent. We'll try to be a good parent at Mint, I think, you know? Oh, she's sad again. Dang it. She's angry and she's sad. Sad bomb from emotional quirk. And then she's sad. The idea of being a parent to a new baby doesn't sound any better than in the previous trimester. There's still time to make a difficult decision, but the julep is still not sure. No matter what she does, the damage is done. Life is permanently altered. Poor girl. I mean, it is pretty daunting. Like, you know, yeah, your life is gonna change forever. How about you cry it out, actually? Yeah, why not cry? Who cares if you wake up your fiance? He should feel very inconvenienced by your, or he shouldn't feel inconvenienced by your emotions. You're right, it's Rose. Yeah, it does sound like not an ideal parent. I'm so excited to do this challenge. Thank you for the inspo. I'm glad. Yeah, we're gonna be doing it together. Yeah, because I'm still in Mint, so. We'll basically be doing it at the same time. All right, let's fix that toilet because apparently we broke it with our sadness. Let's get some leftovers too before you go back to bed. You okay? Again, some water. Dehydrated after crying. Poor thing. Shamagra Gathara. Abivo. Chori Varpasa. Like, how's a suggestive conversation, but he's like fixing the toilet and she's very sad. You know, sometimes your emotions really do be all over the place. Okay, just put that down somewhere, please. Thank you. I'll take care of that. Let's clean that up. Thank you. Yeah, he's about to start burnout again. He's, like, always in between, like, burnout and midlife crisis. Like, his midlife crisis is still going on. I don't know if it tells you how much longer it's gonna be. Like, I know you can make it go by faster, but I don't know. We'll see. All right, one more day of work. We got this. Maybe we can get, like, one more promotion today. Oh. She is not having a good time. Did she make another puddle, or she just didn't finish with the other puddle? I'm just gonna have him come into it after you're done eating. Can you mop up this puddle? She's having a rough time. She is definitely not having an easy pregnancy, which I feel like is nice because, like, yeah, not everyone has an easy pregnancy. All right, we'll deal with the puddle later. Looks like part of it already dried. So just go to sleep. Go to sleep. She's had a pretty easy life up to this point, so I feel like, yeah, you know, the Lord makes it, what is it? This challenges our toughest soldiers? I don't know. I don't remember. I'm joking, obviously, but I don't remember what the saying is supposed to be. Good night, Yodo. Have a good one. Thanks for hanging out with us today. You next time. Yeah, I'll definitely try to stream tomorrow. I mentioned this earlier. I'll try to stream tomorrow, but I have an appointment in the morning and then maintenance is supposed to come. So if they come during the morning and I'm not worried that they'll interrupt our stream, then we'll stream. But if they haven't come yet, then I'll probably wait until they do come. But, you know, I don't know. It's all up in the air. And then I won't be streaming Wednesday because that's Valentine's Day. Easy pregnancy sounds like a myth, right? Like, they make it seem like it's so nice, but, like, it sounds like most of the time it's not nice. So, not really buying their lies. going to make some breakfast. BRB, enjoy your breakfast. Thank you for the lurk. She's got only negative emotions right now. Back pain from pregnancy. The baby is pulling on Julep's back. She's hungry. She has an unwanted pregnancy. She's not ready for this. Poor thing. Yeah, we'll definitely get you some food when you wake up. You want just like a normal meal instead of like acai bowl. Just eat. Just eat your feelings, my girl. Eat your feelings. I think he can offer a massage too, but he does have work in like a little bit, so I don't know if we'll have time for a massage. I know, poor girl. You know what? I think she deserves an epidural. I've already decided for her. I'm gonna make life easy for you, girl. You're gonna get an epidural. You're welcome. She needs a cake. It was literally just her birthday and she had a cake, but you know, cake anytime. She's allowed to have cake whenever she wants. Definitely. She deserves it. Oh no, her crying while eating breakfast. My poor baby girl. Yeah, she's real upset. And then because she has the emotional bomb quirk, because she's almost a celebrity, that is not helping matters. A little quivering lip, poor baby. Night on the town. I mean, maybe that'll help things. Like, her and Keanu used to go on dates, like, a lot. Like, you would ask her out, like, every day. So, you know, maybe she needs a little bit of that, like, back in her life. Why did you put it there? All right, why don't you use the toilet and, I don't know, cry it out maybe. Cry it out a little bit. You know, a nice, good pre-work cry, I feel like is real good. That'll help. I wish that trash can existed in real life, right? Where it gives you money every time you throw things away. I would love that. You gonna go cry? Good girl. Here, you can give yourself a pep talk. Maybe she checks out her baby bump. Maybe it'll make her happier. Girl, you're gonna dehydrate yourself. Please. Oh my god. She's gonna go to work and her eyes are gonna be so red. She's gonna be so snotty. Oh, just a... Okay. Yeah, see? You're a cutie patootie. It's okay.
Oh, Rojba.
You're okay. Baya? Everything will be fine. Here, why don't you read the baby? She likes reading. Aww. Look at her. Appreciating her little baby bump. I mean, it's already a big baby bump. She's already in her second trimester. Oh, maybe I shouldn't have done that. Daunting reality from baby bump. As Julep looks in her reflection, she can't help but wonder how much more her body will change over the coming months, whether she will ever be able to regain the sense of control she once felt. Suddenly, a wave of nausea washes over her, and Julep turns away from the mirror, wishing she could make this all go away. All right, never mind. That was a bad idea. Never mind. I'm stupid. Don't do that. This will be my first time seeing the new baby update. Oh, with like the infants and stuff. I like the infants. I think they're cute. Are you late for work? My bad, dude. Literally, my bad. All right, just go cry it out more. Maybe that's what we should have started with again. She's having a crisis. She really is. I think I made it worse. Poor baby girl. She's definitely not getting a promotion now. She's supposed to be focused when she goes to work. Poor baby girl. Alright, your knees are okay. Here, why don't you give yourself a pep talk? Try to calm down a little. But don't look at your bump. We'll use this mirror so that way she could just look at herself in the face. Pretend the bump's not there. Oh, never mind. Another failure. I'm so sorry. What can I do? She already is happy from the food. Yeah, she's just gonna be sad. She's gonna be in third trimester in 14 hours. So yeah, probably next time we play this, we'll have a new baby. And hopefully when the baby's here, she's a little happier. And she's gonna be busy with work too, which I feel like adds to the stress. Here, why don't you go... Yeah, you start work really soon, but you can play a little bit of chess, maybe it'll distract you. Yeah, hopefully. Like, honestly, like, I sound like I'm very, like, inconvenienced by her emotions, but, like, I like that, you know, with a mod that you can kind of have a variety of reactions to being pregnant, and if this is how the game decides she wants to be, or the mod decides that this is how she's going to react to pregnancy, like, I'm kind of cool with it, because I think it's nice that it's not just, like, a default happy time, you know? Same, yeah, I like having variety. I think that's a big reason why I use mods. Because, yeah, if everything went smoothly, it wouldn't be as interesting. What mod is it? This one is the Lupino RPO mod. I think that's what we decided it was called earlier. Yeah, RPO. So it comes with a lot of different mods, so you can choose which ones you want, which ones you don't. So I don't have, like, all the, like, there you can kind of pick and choose, like, a bunch of different, like, little side dishes for the mod. So I don't have every side dish that the mod offers. I just have the ones that I want. So yeah, when you check out the mod, just know that you don't necessarily have to take all of that, because there's, like, yeah, there's, like, sexually transmitted diseases in there, and I just didn't want to mess with that. I'm like, if I had them in my game, Keanu would definitely have them, you know, right? He just kind of like, knowing our luck, he probably would have given us some sort of disease, right? Because because we weren't exclusive, like, at all in the beginning, but he would still get super jealous, and you never know, you know, can't trust him. Are we late for work? No, she doesn't start till 10. I scared myself. I thought she started at 9. I forgot to start the club gathering so we could get the bonus, but that's okay. Oh no. I was, like, zoning out a little bit, and I just hear her screaming, crying. All right, well, we're going to work soon, so, you know, dry your tears, my girl. We could also leave, like, our fame behind, and I think that would help with how many outbursts she's having. But right now, like, you know, in your second trimester, and you're feeling emotional, I think it just kind of works. It kind of works for her vibe right now, so I'm not, like, intent on changing it. All right, let's get in our science-y outfit. What should we do first? Read a book? Yeah, maybe. Oh, test alien environment? Yeah, maybe we'll do that one. Test alien environment. And then make embiggen serum? I don't know if I have all the stuff for that. No, I don't. I need apples. Is there an apple tree? Isn't this an apple tree? I need to go into debug and just, like, get all the ingredients we need. We did that a couple streams ago. I should probably just do it again. Yeah, we'll finish this workday and then we'll probably end stream. And just as a reminder, I want to stream tomorrow, but it depends on if my apartment maintenance comes when they're supposed to. They're doing, like, their annual, like, checks on something. I don't remember. I'll check the letter. And yeah, I don't want to, like, I don't want to stream if I'm worried that they're gonna, like, interrupt. So that'll depend on if I stream tomorrow. And then Wednesday I won't be streaming because it's Valentine's Day. So I'll see you guys next on Thursday. Sorry for the lack of streams this week, but, you know, that's just sometimes how it goes. I think I'll probably be able to stream all week next week. So at least there's that. Because I don't think I have work next week.
Finale.
Huh. Like, she's feeling focused right now, which is good. I feel like the chest definitely helped. Yeah, I think it's an off week for my work, because usually I work, like, every other week, but sometimes I get an extra week. Back from my lurk maid, Brecky, what'd you make? Because you said you're in the UK, right? I actually don't really know, like, what people eat for breakfast in the UK. Toast, right? They're like, toast is a big thing. I tried a new diner. Well, not really a diner. I guess I would call it a diner. I tried a new diner this weekend, and I tried their biscuits and gravy because that's always, like, my go-to. And for the UK people out there, if there's any UK people, biscuits are different. The biscuits are different. I forget what your guys' equivalent is, but don't worry. It's and it's like country gravy, so it's, like, different. But yeah, it was pretty good. I liked it. I made some toasted protein bagels with smashed avocado and some veggie sausage. That sounds bomb. That sounds so good. We had some really good bagels this weekend too. All right, and then work out on treadmill for 30 minutes. Let's do that. Bangers and mash. IDK. Scones are close to biscuits. Yeah, they're more of like a scone than like a cookie. Biscuits are cookies here. The equivalent to your biscuits would be scones or muffins. Yeah, so it was more like a scone, like... yeah, like a country style scone with country gravy. So it's like brown gravy, but like usually it's like mixed with like some sort of cream or something like that. This one tasted like it was almost mixed with like cream cheese. Like it was really like rich. And like, yeah, it kind of tasted like cream cheese, which is interesting. I feel like I haven't had like biscuits and gravy that like it like kind of goes that way, but it came with some really good potatoes. It was really good. Bangers and mash, I swear nobody calls it that here. What is it called? I feel like bangers and mash are iconic. Like, I feel like I would just want to have it so that way I could say it, because it just sounds like a fun thing to say. But if you're not calling it that, then what's the point? it's a fun word or a fun food to say. Sausage and mash? I'm not even in the UK. I vote for bangers and mash.
Yeah.
We usually have it with baked beans. And like okay, so as a Mexican, I just can't wrap my head around the baked bean like the way you guys like style and like pair your baked beans. I feel like I'm very confused. I would go to the UK and ask for bangers and mash and get laughed as I guess I'm gonna ask for bangers and mash. Or we have toad in the hole. Okay, that sounds fun. What's that? Excuse me, girl, I told you to tinker. I didn't ask for a crying session. Sorry, that sounded mean. I'm sorry. Wait, have you had baked beans before? Like, I've had chili beans. Like, I don't know if I've just had baked beans. They have scotch eggs, too. I want to try it. I have no idea what under these are. I'm going to have to do research. Because I love food, and I would love to go to, like, the UK at some point and, like, try all the food. Because I'm just really curious. Okay, and then I think I did see like a pregnancy thing pop up on here. Participate in pregnancy forums, research pregnancy and parenting tips. Yeah, maybe these things would help her too. So we could do some research. It's sausage and Yorkshire pudding. We usually have it with mashed potatoes and onion gravy. I'm so curious about Yorkshire pudding. Like I hadn't like really known it was a thing until they put it in The Sims, and I was like, I'm really curious about Yorkshire pudding. Try haggis. I feel like I would want to try it. I've tried some really interesting things just because I'm really curious. So I feel like, yeah, I would kind of just want to try everything. Haggis sounds interesting. IDK if I try it. I'm like, I don't know, I'm pretty adventurous. I feel like I'd be like down to try it. Yeah, right, I'm down to try all the food. The blood sausage, I want to try that. Oh, yeah, see, I feel like that's not honestly that weird to me. I know that might sound odd, but I think, oh, shoot, she's about to pee herself. I think just with, like, my, like, the different foods that are really popular in the Philippines and in Mexico, I don't know, like, it just doesn't seem that, like, doesn't sound that bad to me. like, I'm kind of down to try almost anything. I forget, because yeah, we were talking about dinuguan, which is pork and pork's blood, and how there was kind of a similar thing. My friend sent me like a dish that sounded kind of similar, but it was like mixed with like a bunch of extra stuff. You always give me your blood sausage, but yeah, like if it was like an experience, I would try it, but like I literally have that soup like once a week. I don't want to eat that once a week. I'll say I don't eat a lot of British food. The tea is most of our food was stolen from other cultures. True. Like, what did you guys have before the spice trade? A serious question. Just kidding. In fact, literally 9% of the British food was stolen. Yeah, I believe it. Our iconic drink tea was taken from India. Very true. I mean, like, a lot of cultures learn from each other. But yeah, I guess if you're talking about the UK, it's more of like a stealing kind of situation. Good night, Simsy loves a lot. Wait, coal. Unseasoned coal. All right, it says to clone an object. Do I have an object to clone? Can I clone my voodoo doll? Free voodoo doll, let's go. And chimney soot. Oh my gosh. Bonze. Drive it like you stole it. Oh my goodness. Yeah, like a lot of cultures like adapt their food, but I guess if we're talking about the British, we're going to use a little different context here. This brings up an interesting question. What is U.S. culture? I don't know, especially like as like a Californian immigrant family American. I feel like there's it depends on a lot of different factors, because yeah, I feel like my specific brand of like America is very different from like someone who grew up like small town Midwest or something like that. Like, I feel like when people think of American, like literally the Super Bowl, that's probably like that happened yesterday. Like, that's probably what people think of when they think of America. But I mean, hey, I watched it, so guilty. IDK, actually, I think we eat a lot of vegetables, pastry-based dishes like pies. I mean, honestly, that kind of sounds good. I'm also French, so the food is a lot better there. True. Okay, so at least you have that option if you want it. Okay, I don't think cloning the voodoo doll counted. Maybe a book? Okay, you can't clone a book. A crystal? Does that count as an object? I mean, okay, there's it literally said clone object. Oh, it did it. Oh, might as well just do it again. Football, yeah, football, baseball is like considered like all American. Like, I used to be a really big sports person when I was younger. Now it's just kind of like a thing that, like, yeah, if everyone else is kind of excited about it, then I'll be excited about it. I used to be a bigger sports fan when I was younger. All right, I think all of my stuff is tainted. So I'm kind of scared about trying any of my serums. But we can also give away. Okay, it has to. Oh, actually, we give it away. Okay, so give away a tainted serum. Okay, let's give away this tainted need fixer. Can you take this off my hands, please? Here you go. Thanks. When I think of American food, I think of, like, Taco Bell or Popeyes, which is funny because Taco Bell is, like, fake Mexican food. And then Popeyes, I think, is, yeah, it's technically supposed to be, like, Southern food, I think is what they're trying to be. I think it's supposed to be, like, Louisiana food. On the same way, if I'm at a Super Bowl party, I get really into it. But if not, I get, right, I just kind of get excited when other people are excited. Like, I don't know, just kind of, I really vibe off of other people's vibes. All right, we have to freeze three people, and I'm not worried about it. Yeah, Louisiana chicken, right? Popeyes is good. Yeah, I have no clue. Yeah, the thing about America is, like, yeah, I feel like if you ask everyone, like, what they think America is, like, everyone would give, like, a different answer. Ask AI. Someone should ask AI. I know your proportions are huge, like large here in the UK is medium in America. Jealous, honestly. Yeah, we have really big portions here, which is good because I'm pretty good with leftovers. It depends on what it is, but sometimes like some things are better if you just eat it all at once. All right, I don't want to freeze our friend. Is there another coworker around to freeze? Here we go. Haha, found you. She's very sad still about her pregnancy, but maybe freezing people would make her feel better. I don't know if this is cheering her up. I really want to visit the States at some point, but it's so expensive to fly over there. Yeah, I was looking at flying over to where you guys are in the UK. And yeah, it's very expensive. I just feel like flights have just gotten so pricey. And even though, like, you know, I make more money now than when I was, like, a teenager, like, I'm still not able to, like, travel the way, like, I thought I was going to be able to in my 20s. You know, it's just kind of a sad thing that I thought I was going to be able to travel by this point. But everything just got way more expensive than I thought it was. All right. Trim overgrowth. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, because I was looking for something to do for my birthday trip, and I was just kind of checking prices to fly, like, anywhere basically. Like, I checked like Korea because that's where my sister lives. I'm like, oh, maybe we should visit her. Very expensive. I think I looked at like Edinburgh because I was really curious about that. I know I said that so wrong. I'm so sorry. Like, I checked out a few places and it was just like, yeah, it was so expensive to go anywhere. Honestly, UK is so rubbish at the moment. You're not missing out. It's not the same place it used to be. Yeah, I don't know. Like, I feel like I'm just always really curious about like history and architecture, and I feel like that's a really great thing to see. Like the food I'm more like curious about. Like, I'm not excited for British food. Like, I think it's more of just like a curiosity thing. I guess there's a little bit of excitement there too. Yeah, I don't know. I'm like I kind of just want to experience it, because it's like, yeah, I've never left the country at all, so I just want to try things, you know. What is the most visited state for people overseas? New York, Florida, Disney World, California. Well, yeah, I don't know. I feel like New York and California are very popular. I feel like when I see people like are like, oh, in the US for the first time, a lot of times it is like one of those. I feel like you pronounce it great. Dang, I never pronounce anything right. I think Bob's New York, since it's closer, cheaper to fly. That's true. I guess it depends on like, yeah, where you're coming from. Yeah. Yeah, because a lot of people do travel just for, like, the Disney parks. I mean, that's kind of what I would do, so I'm not judging. New York and Florida. Interesting. I feel like Florida is, like, pretty American, depending on who you ask. But then I feel like New York is so unique, but it's, like, uniquely American as well, in a way. But it's, like, its own place, though. Like, it's so hard to, like, pin down, like, that New York vibe and, like, explain it. But it is, like, kind of uniquely American, I feel like. You guessed it. Good job. Yeah, because of Disney, I feel like. Florida's apparently insane, though. I've been a couple times. I never really saw... Oh, no, well, we missed a fight. It didn't happen in front of us, but it happened while we were there. And I saw some pretty, like, insane shirts. I'm like, wow, that's what you really believe in? That you're going to put that on a shirt? Very interesting. Disney World is a bubble within Florida, but we've seen some weird... Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Yeah, and especially because it's, like, a Disney park, like, it's not really just Floridians there, you know? It's, like, people from around the world there. The Milton Keys in the UK? I don't know if I've ever heard of... No, wait, Keyans? I don't know if I've ever heard of that. I was shocked by how flat it is. Yeah, someone who's grown up around, like, mountains and hills, like, her whole life. It's wild, like, when things are just, like, flat. I was living in Hawaii at the time when I went to Florida. Oh, Hawaii is so beautiful. Like, just driving to go, like, get dinner is just, like, a beautiful experience. We have a lot of family that lives in Hawaii. We were actually going to go this summer, but I don't think we're going anymore. Milton Keynes is a horrible place. Oh, okay. Good thing I never heard about it. We do have some ads coming up in a couple minutes, by the way. I know. Oopsies. I'm just going to up your hunger a little bit. Just a little bit. Let's see. Can we use some microscope again? I like how our coworkers are just frozen. I'm just trying to get us through the workday. She might still get promoted. We'll see. I'm the opposite. Seeing mountains is shocking. Yeah, especially here in Washington, like the big mountain, Mount Rainier, like if the day is clear, you can see it from like so far away. It's really nice. It's really beautiful. I already read your message. The ad thing popped up and it looked like it was a new message. But yeah, I've always grown up around hills and mountains, like first from California and then Washington. So yeah, flatland, if anything, freaks me out. Like we went to Vegas once. So I'm like, yep, that's a lot of desert. Wow. I would love to visit Hawaii, but I've heard some residents that there is supply shortage and it's best not to visit due to what's happening. Yeah, like honestly, tourism to Hawaii is very unethical. And especially after like a lot of the things that happened in Maui recently, it's just like, yeah, it's like they need to really focus on, you know, assisting the residents before they're so worried about resuming tourism. But this has literally been going on like with different instances, like for like over 100 years. So I just think that they just don't care. I'm from Texas, so we have small little baby hills. I hate being landlocked. Yeah, that's rough. Mostly flat though. Oh, gotcha. Yeah, in one of my hometowns, it's like all hills. Rather just admire from afar, respect their land. Tourism can be so harmful. It really can be. Like, I think a lot of people don't realize. I think they think that they're helping a lot of times, but you know, there's negatives and positives to everything. Ads are coming up. Here's some heart jellies if you guys want to gamble. I'm gonna stay on just to finish the workday and wrap up stream. Oh, we didn't get a promotion. Dang it. It's because she's so sad. We're almost done with the career. I think we only have two more promotions to go through, or technically one. No, two more, I think, because we're on level 8 right now. No, so then, yeah, I think it's technically... No, because you have to go from 9 to 10. Never mind. Sorry, I'm bad at math. we have more time to get the promotion after she's not, you know, hormonal. let me see. Yes, enjoy the gambles. All right, let me take care of her needs and let the ads run, and then we'll wrap up stream. I try to race the ads sometimes to try to like finish stream before the next ad comes, but my timing is always off. I'm always just a little off. Yeah, he's got mental fog from burnout, feeling insecure because he's jealous, rat race from midlife crisis, and then utterly enamored. What do you want? A quick question. Bly, Alexander, and I were planning to spend some casual friend time together. Should I do it? Yeah, sure, go ahead. I don't know who you are.
Oh,
Alright, she's got back pain from pregnancy, so maybe when he's out of the shower, we'll try to offer a massage. I think there's, like, a special pregnancy massage that they can do, too. I'll have to look at, like, to see if there's an option through the mod for, like, a special pregnancy one. Being with Arya was wondering if I want to go over to her house and hang out. I do kind of want to see her kids. I am very curious. Ooh, a fun fact. I'll wait till the ads are done to do the fun fact. But I'll think of one. If I forget, please someone remind me. All right, let's go check out because it looked like she had triplets and I'm really curious if it was triplets. Okay, I see one infant. This one's Lionel Lothario. All right, where are the other ones? Any other children around? So far, no. There's a lot of clothes on the ground. Do they have an upstairs? Where's all the other kids? Did they get taken away? Where are the rest of your kids? I only see one. Where are the other ones? The baby's just outside. Just one, though. Like, we checked earlier, and it said she had three. Where are the other ones? Should I... Will the baby tell me? Hey, baby, where are your siblings at? Asked to be introduced by? Where are the other ones? I'm very concerned right now. Quinn Lothario. Oh, okay, so this is one of her kids. So he's a teen. Okay, so two are accounted for. Oh, and Jen. Okay, so two of them are teens. Okay, for some reason... Were you guys always here? Who are your parents? Aw, we're being introduced to that baby. Maybe meeting a baby will make it easier for her to like babies. Oh, maybe not. The baby screams in my ear. Oh, yep, the baby doesn't like me. Bounce it, bounce it. Uh-oh. We're not getting along. The baby hates us. The baby hates us. When was a young adult? Really? Dang, when did she have all these kids? Oh, yeah, this one's a young adult and the other one was a teen. You're right. Welcome back, guys, from ads. So we went to go visit our friend because I was curious if she had triplets. I only saw one baby and I was freaking out. But no, she has one adult kid and one teen. And then this is the newest baby and the baby hates us. So I don't think it's helping with our baby fears that this baby doesn't like us. Oh, we're just gonna put them on the ground. We're like, all right, we're done. Looks like Julep befriended a spirited sim. Spirited sims have a lust for life, spreading good vibes wherever they go, easily becoming the life of the party. In terms of sim preference, would you say that Julep likes spirited sim? Sure, why not? Small talk to a baby, like, yeah, let's try to salvage this. Oh, okay. Yeah, the baby hates us. Cry baby from failed introduction. Yuck, Julep thought that toddlers were bad, but these infants are completely unmanageable. Could someone take this thing away from me? And then what's this one say? Crying infant from crying infant. The world would be oh so much better if the crying would stop. She is not into this. Mia work. No. Okay, so apparently I never met her sons. He's in D&D club. Good for him. I didn't know you had all these kids. Okay, hold on. Let me help her with her outfit. Girl, you're embarrassing. Hello, child that I didn't know she had. I work in coffee shop and little kids always come running up to the counter and say hello when I'm making drinks and I'm always like, awkward. It's a child, right? You're like, hi. Like, I like my goddaughter, and I like my nephew, and I like our nieces and stuff, and our other nephew, but, like, yeah, random kids, like, I'm always just like, should I even talk to you? Like, does this make me a creeper talking to, like, a random child? Like, where is your parents? All right, I don't know. Maybe we should talk to her about pregnancy again. Maybe that'll help. Since she's had a kid before. Express feelings about pregnancy. Maybe we'll talk to the kids about it, too. How would you feel if you were unwanted? This is coming from someone who wants to work with kids for a living. You're like, awkward. Honestly, what do you talk about with random kids? I feel like it's so creepy. I don't know. With my goddaughter, we kind of just talk about, like, everything. Like, we mostly play, like, pretend. Like, we usually play, like, hair salon or something. But, like, I'm not going to do that with a random kid. I work in the children's department at the library, and I'm just like, do you like Bluey? Do you like Bluey? I do like Bluey. I could talk to kids about Bluey. Honestly, do you like Spider-Man? Do you iPad? Where's your iPad? Where's your parents and where's your iPad? Bluey, Spider-Man, right? I can do that. I can do that. All right, I'm gonna just hope her needs here because I don't want her to pass out pregnant at someone else's house.
Grinoy Foiby Basu.
All right. I wonder if there's anything else we could do about, like, the pregnancy and stuff.
Lamina Galpa Vibitev.
I don't know. What can we talk to you about this to this guy? Maybe we should just talk to anybody who will listen. Yeah, we just announce our pregnancy. Alright, I guess we could go home then. We met the random baby. We met some of her kids. I guess we could just go home. I was just kind of curious, because when it said that she had three kids, I thought that meant that she had triplets, but no, she already had two kids. I got any games on your phone? That's probably what they're thinking. They're like, maybe I should ask this adult if I can play with their phone. Yeah, I used to have, like, a dress-up game on my phone, and my goddaughter was, like, obsessed with it. And I was like, oh, I don't have that game on my phone anymore, like, the next time we went to go visit. She's like, that's okay. She's so sweet. Yeah, I usually just let her play hair salon on me and just, like, tangle up my hair. I'm like, this is my job as a godmother. Just let her tangle my hair, playing hair salon. I had a kid last Saturday come up to the front desk and just stare. I don't know if I could do that. Like, if a kid was creepy, like, if they were, like, haunted acting, I don't know if I could do that. I'd be like, oh my gosh, like, oh my god. Like, I'm trying to talk to her, but she wouldn't answer. No, that would freak me out so much. I'd be so freaked out. Kids are scary. I don't like it. Kids are scary. I was like, okay. You're like, please don't haunt me. When I worked in shipping, this one guy was being a butt, but his kid kept wanting to talk to me, and I'm like, please leave, both of you. You're like, you're making my job so much harder. Oh, don't forget fun fact. Yeah, sorry. I was waiting for the fun fact. I was waiting to do the fun fact until the ad was over. Fun fact. What is my fun fact? Oh, is she crying more? Oh, no, okay. Was that excited or happy? Or excited or not? Oh, God. Okay, never mind. She's tense. What did I do? Did I do something wrong? No going back. Well, that child will be born soon. It's too late to consider stopping this. Julep has to go through with it now. And being a parent to a new baby, who knows how she'll make it all work. Poor thing. Okay, she's going to have an emotional meltdown. Go ahead. Oh, he's burnt out, too. Can we have, like, one crisis at a time? He's just such an attention seeker. It's like, she's the one pregnant. Don't make this about you. It says, Keanu is burned out. Burnout negatively impacts work performance, promotions, energy, fun, skill gain. He'll recover over time, but taking breaks and relaxing will help speed up recovery. If Keanu stays burned out for too long, his condition may get worse. He's an adult, right? Not a young adult. Yeah, he's going to be an elder in 11 days. Poor guy. Maybe he'll chill out in his older age. All right, fun fact before I forget. Fun facts. I recently got back into jewelry, and I'm trying to decide if I want to get a new piercing. Part one of the fun fact is I'm a silver girl, but I do want to get, like, one set of gold things, so that way I have, like, gold stuff if I want to wear it. I did get this necklace. It says bookish on it, in, like, a subscription box, so this is, like, the only, like, gold necklace I have right now, but I do want to get, like, some gold earrings to go with it. But yeah, I know that gold looks better on my skin tone, but I prefer silver. My engagement ring and my wedding ring, here, let me see if I have zoom on, is also silver. This is what it looks like. But yeah, I'm a silver jewelry girly. That's my fun fact. White gold, yes. Well, you know what I mean. Like, it looks silver. Sorry, Ryan bought the ring, so he knows what he's talking about. Actually. Are you gonna do some yoga? Oh, that's good. You should do some yoga. Yeah, I feel like a lot of people with like my coloring and stuff like that wear gold, and I love that for them, but I've just always liked like silver better. That's just, I don't know, it's just always been my style. Whose food is this? Is this yours? I don't know. She's just gonna eat this random food that was sitting here. You know, you're pregnant. I'm not gonna judge. She's so pissed. He's so angry. Aw, he's like, it's okay, baby. Here, maybe we should go to like another
Nkoya. Huh.
Another like pregnancy thing. Try to reassure about pregnancy. Oh. Let's try that again. She'll probably hate it, but maybe it'll help. Oh, he's very tense too. I feel like this isn't going to be a very like productive conversation if they're both in a bad mood.
Fimpa? Kazuni Bull.
Oh, Maroba Yellig Panel.
Oh, did that help? Oh, good job. Oh, you did a good job. I wasn't expecting it to be a good thing. Organized to provide for the baby? What does that do? She's so big. Is she in her third trimester now? Yeah, third trimester. Cute. Sorry, random, but does anyone here have the For Rent pack? Debating if it's safe to get her some games breaking. Yeah, I don't know if they've fixed anything. Like, I know a lot of people have been avoiding getting it because it can cause issues with, like, corrupting save files, I think is the main thing. I'm not sure if there's anything else. I haven't had an issue with it. I do have the For Rent pack. I don't play with it. Like, I don't build with it and stuff like that, so I don't know if that makes it maybe better. And I do go to the world sometimes, but yeah, like I don't notice anything like broken about it, but I have heard that, yeah, it is causing issues for people, and I don't think they've released a fix yet. So if you're worried about it, I mean, I don't even think it's on sale. So if you don't mind waiting, maybe just wait till it's fixed and or on sale. But, yeah, I haven't had any issues with it personally. Here, why don't you get some sleep too, and then we'll wrap up stream. That's rare. Thanks for your feedback. Yeah, I hope that helps. Thankfully, you know, knock on everything. Nothing's happened to like my save files. I try to back up my save files every now and then too, and I feel like that helps. All right, let's go ahead and wrap up stream. Thank you guys for hanging out. I'm feeling much better. At the beginning of stream, I was a little out of sorts. But you guys always find a way to help me out. So thank you guys so much. I haven't. It's been good for me so far. Same for me, yeah, but I have heard other people having issues, so that's always something to keep in mind. Thank you for streaming, love your show. Thank you guys so much for hanging out. I'm gonna find someone for us to raid. Again, tomorrow's stream is up in the air. Depends on how my appointment goes and how if maintenance shows up when they're supposed to. And then I won't be streaming Wednesday for sure, because it is I almost said Thanksgiving. It's Valentine's Day. thank goodness. Let's see. Thank you for the good stream. Oh, thank you. I'm glad you guys liked it. Thank you. Thank you so much for hanging out. I'm just gonna find someone to raid. Let's see. Excuse me.
Ba-la-la-la.
Thank you for the follow. Thank you. Thank you. Maybe over here? Glad to find your stream. Nice meeting you all, even though it was mostly quiet. Oh, no worries. We're a very lurker-friendly stream, so if you like to keep quiet and just observe, that is totally fine. I do that a lot, too, so don't even worry. Have a lovely date. Happy Valentine's. And see you soon. Yes, everyone have a happy Valentine's. Even if you don't have a partner, do something nice for yourself. Yes, good night, good night. All right, we're going to raid D-Prince. He's on a stream team with me. He's very, very sweet, and he's playing some Animal Crossing. We love Animal Crossing. And I feel like you guys don't get to see a lot of it from me, but I know we love Animal Crossing. So let's go ahead and go say howdy to him. Make sure you grab a raid message. Grab my animated emotes if you're a sub, the one with my wiggles. And then if you're not a sub, grab the pop corgi. You should have access to that one. But yeah, hopefully I'm able to stream tomorrow. I guess I'll post an announcement if I can't. in the Discord. And then yeah, Wednesday I probably won't post a announcement that I won't stream, because I'm just telling you guys now that I won't stream on Wednesday because it's Valentine's Day. Anything else? Check out my YouTubes. If you're behind on Not So Berry, I uploaded all the VODs to my stream VOD channel. That's the second link there. And if you don't follow me there, please feel free to subscribe there, because I have all of the requirements to hit YouTube partner on that account, like the watch hours and everything. I just don't have the subscribers. So a lot of people watch my stuff, they just don't subscribe. So if you want to subscribe over there, that would help me out. But other than that, yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Be kind to the next chat. We love Rio. So yeah, be kind to the next chat, be kind to yourself, and I'll see you guys hopefully tomorrow if everything works out. But yeah, see you guys soon. Bye-bye.